Kick back at the castle, pull on tuck, get these eyes one battle. They gon' eat shells, I'ma feed them ammo. Barrel got big knife, caught a bit Rambo. Pour another cup, baby, go ahead, smoke some weed. Hit that telegram, yeah, you know I got what you need. I love all my hoes, I ain't never met no tease.
Yeah.
Chi-town stand up.
South side.
We in the north side today. I think I'm a little loud.
Okay.
Hey, we got Mr. Warren Greed in the motherfucking building today.
Yeah. Warren Greed, welcome to the BFR Podcast.
Oh, hello.
Dude, did you ever play basketball?
Never played basketball. Well, I did in like fourth grade and then no one passed me the ball, so then I stopped playing.
Motherfuckers.
Were you tall in fourth grade or you hit a growth spurt?
I hit a growth spurt around middle school. So it wasn't that tall. I mean, I was slightly tall. I don't know. I'm from Minnesota, so like
you're regular size.
Yeah, I was kind of like I was 6'4", so it was pretty tall, but I definitely wasn't the tallest.
Beans, I think it'd be funny if he just blur out his shirt the whole entire episode.
I was just going to ask if he could turn it inside out. Yeah. Fuck that.
Wait, this is...
Yeah, no, we don't...
No,
we don't fuck with Alonzo Cant too.
Yeah, the website, you can blank that out. The rest of it, I guess. It just looks like a movie.
But... Ernest Goes to Damascus.
Yeah, it's stupid. That's right. So dumb.
Yeah, that's fine. I thought so.
That's for your money back.
Hey, dude, turn on that ring light, please.
Want me to add you?
So how's your day going, dude? You drove all the way out here?
Thank you.
What side of town are you from?
I'm living kind of in the central side now, you know. I'm right near the Pearl now. But
Oh, that's a nice little
downtown.
Yeah, it's nice.
No wonder he came in shitting on the house.
Oh, yeah. Well,
no, I was telling you.
Was this like, not built 150 years ago?
This is not historic architecture.
No, but I was on this side of town because I was visiting my sister who lives just south of here, down that 211 there, and she lives in pretty much the same model house, and it's just it's crazy. It's,
motherfuckers, dude.
I've walked.
It's pretty cool for thieves, though.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, they know exactly where to go. Yeah,
because all the houses are the same.
Yeah, dude, Marvin, that other guy. What is his Marvin? Fucking from Home Alone.
They would have loved Marv, the Wet Bandits.
The Wet Bandits. They would have loved it. They only had to stake out one house, and they knew the rest of the fucking neighborhood.
Yeah,
it's great. Yeah,
I used to live with her, and I used to live in that bedroom.
Really?
And there, yeah.
That's that, funny. That's where my brother lives.
It's getting that's real true. Creepy, dude.
Yeah. Did she have a lot of problems with it?
Not so far. I mean, nothing major, but you know, I mean.
I haven't either, but I heard this builder sucks and I'm like,
it's fine.
Oh, is it Bob?
No.
D.R.
Horton.
I follow a guy who does home inspections. He's out in Arizona or New Mexico, but he has a lot of problems with this.
I follow him like he's your future victim.
Like, I've gotten those videos like on TikTok where they go around and show the shitty houses.
And that's
really?
Yeah. I see.
There's a gap in the
pull that up. What's his name? Bob Horton?
What did they show?
D.R. Horton. He's a home inspector.
Oh.
And he just inspects homes. And you know, he's not trying to call out these companies, but he does. Yeah, it's that guy? That guy. Yeah. I mean, we're not gonna find any gold, but yeah, if you want to see watch it later.
So this is a very good question. And I think I have the
weakness in
construction. So this is a very good question. And I think I have the answer, but sadly, it's going to be an answer that's pretty much the answer to almost everything, but I also have a solution. So the answer is accountability. Now, I think I have an easy solution. A termite inspector, when he's done with his inspection, he has to send his report to the state. It gets documented. Okay. There is no reason my home inspection report can't also be sent to the state. If I inspect a new build, I should have the ability to send my inspection report to the AZROC. And they look over my report and go, whoa, this builder is not following any of our standards. We need to go send someone out there and see what's going on. they'll send out their inspector and they'll go.
Wait, I don't know which one it is, but there's like, he has videos of him like,
are you seeing it too?
Like nitpicking, yeah.
Yeah.
Like wow.
Like, it'll be like a brand new build, and he'll just like pick it apart. Everything that's wrong.
That's crazy.
What a fucking dickhead, dude.
No.
You don't think that's a no. dickhead move?
He's trying not to protect all. The consumer.
Yeah.
It's to protect us, not the builders.
Big pharma. Yeah.
But I mean, if you're a Mexican, you would not be in favor because you'd be like, hey, bro, that's my shit. You're judging it.
Hey, bro, leave my roof alone.
I built that roof. That's it. Like, fuck you, bro. You don't know how hot it was. I got the best
people at Home Depot to come over and build this.
Yeah. Like, get up there and build it, bro. It's fucking hot. Of course we cut corners. We wanted to get down. Yeah. But so far, my house has been fine.
What pay them more on you?
Yeah. If anything, they probably fuck up in the attic, right? Like, that's a spot like
where you don't go.
Yeah, nobody's really going to come up here. Just,
do you have one?
He's always going.
Yeah, we talked about my attic last.
Yeah, there's a false attic in the, or not
a
false
no, it's
attic.
True. It's a real attic. Yeah.
In the garage. With real people in there. Christ, this guy was touching my house. Real people chained up.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Somebody asked me, do people live in your attic? I said, no, but they do die there.
That's creepy, Beans. Yeah. I've been meaning to talk to you about that.
I've been meaning to. I can't wait to produce that episode to see the little gleam in my eyes that you said I got.
Oh, yeah.
You said it.
That was scary.
Because I was like, fuck.
Have you, speaking of serial killers, have you killed anybody
lately?
No. Just with jokes, you know? And whoever didn't laugh at the joke.
Damn. That's hilarious. How long have you been doing comedy?
I'm 27 now, so like 25 years.
I thought you were gonna say 27 years.
No, I couldn't talk, but I could make some pretty funny farts when I was growing up. You know, about 3 years.
Really?
About 3 years to answer the question.
And how long have you been in San Antonio?
Three and a half, 4 years.
Oh yeah. Shit.
Yeah, so I started here when I moved down here because I just kind of came down here, didn't really know anyone except for my sister.
Is that why you moved?
I moved for a few reasons. It was mostly I was living up in Fargo.
I get it.
Yeah. FBI was on.
Yeah, we don't need to discuss that anymore, right?
Yeah, can we talk about the elephant
we'll
in the
move
room?
On. Here? So what do you think about Fiesta San Antonio?
There is no record of a Warren Greed ever living in Fargo.
That's interesting. It's an interesting last name.
But do you like to take pictures?
No, actually, I hate pictures.
Oh, shit.
They steal your soul.
They're evidence.
Yeah. Oh.
Dummy.
That's terrible.
That was a Jeffrey.
What is your profession? Like, you can't just kill people all day, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, if you kill, you have to go for the people who are on welfare, because then you can keep collecting your checks.
Oh, shit.
Because they often don't realize that these people are missing or
right. Dead, you know? And then you get their food stamp card.
You just keep getting it. And you can pull in like 15 grand a month, you know, if you're efficient with it.
Nobody really cares about them, so nobody reports them missing.
Oh. And 15 grand, dude.
Or you give one of their family members their food stamp cards. Like, here, you're not going to hear from them. But they said, and then they're not going to ask any questions. They just got the food stamp card. They're like, nah, Ralph's fine. And Ralph's cool. Like, his buddy told me.
Barbosa?
He's going on a break.
You think Ralph Barbosa's on food stamps?
He might be. He might be. He's been posting like some shit on Instagram. Like, he's had some bad luck the past 2 weeks or three. And he's been canceling shows and he's like, oh, I just had the worst luck. Like, they keep canceling my flights. And like, I'm like, get a jet. You got to be rich, right? You got to be super rich by now.
How much do you think a jet is? How much is a jet, Rob?
To fly a jet, to rent a jet.
Like, to own one? Yeah.
No, just to rent a jet.
Charter a jet. We're going to get one
from Dallas, Texas to Arizona.
We're going to get one.
Because that's what he was making excuses.
1,200.
See? Exactly.
12 to 18,000.
That is a huge gap. Like 1,200. Let's see the one I'm getting for 1,200.
It's
let's see
the Richie Valens plane. Is what you're getting for 1,200.
Yeah. What? No AI.
Yeah. Do a millionaire. That's a company in San Antonio.
That's here in San Antonio.
Yeah.
I want to blow it up. Every time I see that sign, a millionaire, I just doesn't piss you off?
It pisses you off.
Millionaire.
No, so I'm like, I want to just go and fly there one day. Like,
I hate that pun.
The audacity.
Look
at this.
Oh my God. Like, there's people getting in those planes.
That guy's a piece of shit.
Has to be.
He cheats on his wife, dude.
Millionaire.
With little boys.
Wow.
There's one right there.
That baby.
Poor baby.
That baby's never seen again.
Yeah, but he flew in a fucking plane, in a jet, a private jet. Like, they're not going to have pricing online. This really? Is like an expensive food menu. Like, they don't show the pricing of the steak.
This is for rich people. They don't.
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't give a fuck about the price.
Discount.
Oh, go to reservations.
No, it's probably like, put your email address or something so they can.
Hi. Oh, yeah. I'm definitely reserving. Do I get that one?
See, there it is.
If you go to the Greyhound bus site.
There's prices. There's prices. See what it costs to get to Minnesota.
Now go to Greyhound.
Tell Ralph to take the bus.
I guess we got to fucking take a bus instead.
The FBI just tracking your website. Oh, broke ass motherfucker with a Greyhound after.
Don't worry, he'll open the door if he wants to really get in. $47.99. There you go. Fucking shit.
Dude. I'd probably rather do the Greyhound. That's
downtown Dallas to.
That's kind of the difference between
to the Pearl to your house.
Yeah.
Wow.
There's no bus stop at the Pearl. Come on.
No.
they keep us far away.
Yeah, no, they just drop you. They just leave you at a parking lot.
Oh, $79.
I know. I want like a.
But there's that bus you can go to Austin for $5, right?
Is there?
I've heard.
Yeah.
I thought that was just like a
roommate.
Yeah.
No, I've dropped people off like Ubering down there, and it's just everybody just goes to the same parking lot, and the bus will show up at a certain time.
What is it called?
I don't remember. But you can do $5 bus to Austin.
Yeah.
This is very interesting.
How do you feel about Austin? Have you been out there to do comedy yet?
You know, I've like hit some mics and, you know, I've been out there just for some weekends. It's all right. I haven't done like an actual show. Like, I've done a couple like bar shows there, but like haven't really broken out into there yet. It's all right. It's all right, Austin. It is scary.
Yeah,
for
right?
a white guy walking down the street.
It shouldn't be that scary for a white dude, bro.
If you stay on Sixth Street, it's fine.
Just lay on the floor with the rest of them.
I think it's scary for any guy.
That's not trans, right?
It's not trans, yeah.
Why is it scary?
Because he's white.
Because you were killing people.
Because those are the people that are dying? We're dying? They're not dying anymore, right?
You haven't been to Austin in a while.
Serial, the Ladybird Lake killer?
Yeah.
Is that it?
They kind of chilled out, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The Ladybird Lake Killer.
It kind of calmed down, didn't it?
I thought that was the Street Strangler.
The same thing.
It's the same guy. He's switching the
same
his
same guy.
He went from the Wet Bandits.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
He's rebranding.
Same exact guy.
Yeah.
But ever since we started calling him out on this podcast,
he's died down. Dude.
How to stop going,
right? He started hearing about this fucking BFR podcast making all this noise.
Oh, look, no dude, good that reason. Is only five. Is that $5, Rob?
No, this is for a panorama seat.
Oh, Megabus. Yeah, it is Megabus.
Yeah, but Megabus was still $22.
Nah, it was $5. Somebody, they were like, yeah, it's just $5. You get on there.
They were probably drunk when they told you that. Like $5 times four.
Yeah, that's crazy, but. Yeah, you can get there for $5 in a Tesla.
Buses.
Really?
Very simple. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, man. $5 gets you about. Yeah. Yeah.
How long could I drive nonstop in a Tesla for $5?
Ooh. For an hour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
$10. At least an hour or two.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about, the Amtrak, dude.
Oh, that's a train, though.
They're going to be starting on trains, guys.
Ooh, they have power outlets. And
you ever ran a train on a girl?
No.
Is that awkward? Do you just stand there and wait for your turn? I've always wondered that.
You just jump
pretty
right
much.
Up.
Yeah, I've walked into one.
That's kind of weird.
I walked into one and all the guys were just lined up.
Really?
Yeah. And fucking Hyro was in there. And like one of the guys was smashing her. And then Hyro was in her mouth. And I was supposed to serve him. So I'm like, anybody know where fucking Hyro's at? Like, he just got here. He asked for an 8-ball. I fucking got it ready for him. And I'm looking for him, dude.
Uh-huh.
And I can't find him. And I was like, I knew all the guys were with the some bitch in there. So I was like, I go in there. I go, hey, is Iroh in here? And all the guys are lined up. And I was already on the bed with his dick in her mouth. Like, I'm in the set, G.
Oh, that's that one?
Yeah.
Oh, he was in the front end?
Yeah. No, he cut line, I'm sure, because he had just got there.
Wow.
Well, if your name's Hyrule. You
know, yeah, so. Dude. That's his real name, too.
Real name.
Yeah, his real name is Hyrule.
Yeah.
How do you spell it? Hyrule?
H-A-I-R-O, I think.
Like a... Like an Asian guy? Hero.
Hero. That's what he should have said when I walked in.
Your name is an Asian greeting?
Oh, Ernichiwa.
Yeah, that would have been fucking funny. Hero.
Yeah, Hero. Yeah, dude. When I knew that dude as a kid, he would have like a fucking black book full of girls' phone numbers. Like tons and tons of girls' phone numbers.
Most of them are still alive, too.
I don't think so either, dude. No, I don't think so. That dude's crazy.
But yeah, they were all just lined up waiting to go next.
Wow. What kind of trains were you talking about?
Dude, just trains, man. They're like the good old fashioned Amtrak. I mean, the...
Oh,
my bad.
Amtrak, dude. I just came here to advocate for public transportation. You know, that's something this country's really missing.
Yeah.
And any chance I get to talk about it, I'll talk about it.
You know? Like that one right there. How do you feel about Thomas the Tank Engine?
Well, what is the status of the high-speed rail line from Austin to San Antonio?
It's probably never.
I'm doing some high-detail journalism over here, Beans.
What is that?
How do you feel about Thomas the Tank Engine?
I think he's...
Look at how angry he is right there.
He looks a little angry.
He's probably, fucking pissed.
First of all, wasn't Thomas the train?
Thomas the Tank Engine.
No, he's the Tank Engine.
I feel like this is a fucking Mandela moment. Because I thought it was Thomas the Train or Thomas the...
Thomas the Tank Engine.
George Carlin was Mr. Conductor for a bit.
Wow.
Oh, no way.
So how do you feel about him?
Yeah, I love trains. I just want more train. I want an opportunity.
I think we should all just ride the train more.
We should do a pod from the train.
Dude. Oh, look. And we could get tickets right here. Room at $94.
Have you ever ridden in a train?
Mm-mm.
Have you ever
partake? No.
Just the one at BRAC.
Oh, yeah. At Six Flags. Does that count?
Oh, the one that goes around the park?
But not a real train.
Wow. Have you ever been in a train cross country?
Not killing people, not cross country. No, and that's the problem. You can't.
Miguel Torres did.
Miguel Torres, the boxer.
Right? Is that his name? Was that his name?
Miguel Torres, the boxer.
No, the train killer, South Texas train killer.
He's not from here, so he wouldn't know.
Angel Resendez. There you go.
Yeah, you were really close.
I know.
Mexican serial killer.
You remember him?
Only
no.
But it was just near the railroad tracks. It wasn't on the train.
But he was train hopping and he was killing them.
The railroad killer.
Yeah, man. That dude was crazy, man. When it was happening, it was wild. How old are you, Warren?
He said 27.
27.
27? Yeah, 27. Wow. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, I wasn't born. Wait. Arrested in 1990.
Yeah, you were a kid. Dang.
I was alive.
Dude, do you remember when those prisoners all escaped?
That was crazy, too.
It was like the seven, right?
Yeah.
Texas 7 or something.
You remember?
Like that?
I was thinking they were on the run? Huh?
I was thinking of Con Air for a second.
With Nikki Cage.
Whatever would have happened if they were on a train.
Yeah.
Contract.
Contract.
That's a way better name, too.
That's a sequel.
God
damn. Oh, shit. I love that movie. What are you doing? You're still trying to make reservations?
Like, it's just so cool. I've never been on a train. It's so cool.
Have you ever been trained?
No.
Okay, just making sure.
Thank you.
Sorry, I didn't mean to ask that question of your sister.
It's okay. I knew the answer. My sister's a saint.
She's like Dorothy Mantu.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's hilarious.
I have crippling anxiety, so I don't do anything ever because I'm scared.
Ah, you would never even get hard.
Mm-hmm. She doesn't watch porn.
And I heard it's banned.
It's not.
Not just if you have ExpressVPN.
Two websites have banned themselves. Yeah. And if you have ExpressVPN and if you use
promo code BFR,
you don't have to worry about any of that.
Mm-hmm. You guys are sponsored by ExpressVPN?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Just don't tell them.
100%.
Oh, nice.
Yep.
Yeah. It's one of those.
We keep getting cease and desist, but we don't listen. Mm-hmm. So just, they're more like suggestions.
You're getting cease and desist for giving them free advertising?
Yeah. That's weird. It's like, no, man. We're not going to stop advertising you. Yeah. You know how many people have probably gotten ExpressVPN?
Me, of us? I got it because of us.
Because of us?
Yeah.
People got because of Greg Abbott.
That's like, true.
I've never paid for porn.
If I can't fill my dick, nobody's going to touch theirs.
That's true. Maybe that's why. He did it.
Because he can't
back in off. With the VPN.
Lobby. Out of spite.
Mm. Right? All the stuff he's against, abortion. He's like, I can't get a bitch pregnant.
That's true. Like, fuck yeah.
Why not?
I can't experience the miracle of childbirth. I got
it. Right. Wow.
He's
interesting.
We're on to him.
Right there?
We just fucking cracked the code.
How's he pee?
I don't know if it's.
A tree fell on him.
I know that.
A tree fell on his trunk.
Solid.
How's he pee?
How does he pee?
Like I really hope it's a bag.
He doesn't even know when it's happening.
You should Google that.
Isn't that cool though? You don't even know when it's happening.
When you just
I can't feel when I piss myself. You just got to change it.
Or you shit yourself.
Like a baby.
Yeah. Yeah.
You shit yourself.
That too. Mm. And he lost his sense of smell with COVID. So fuck. He's done. He's good.
Dude, what do you think?
What a life.
What do you think about all that COVID stuff, right? Is it still going on?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I don't know, man. Not a lot of people calling in sick for COVID lately.
Right. But like RFK, he had a bad reaction to the vaccine, right?
Yeah.
And then Greg Abbott, he can't smell.
No, that was a joke.
Oh, I thought that was for real, dude.
I said it so convincingly. No,
yeah. And no. Then my grandma died.
That was a heart attack.
Yeah.
That was a lot.
From the vaccine.
It could have been. They don't investigate those, though.
No?
No. Why would they?
Did you get vaccinated?
How many times?
No, I didn't.
At all?
No.
Wow.
It was I was living out in, I was living in Kerrville at the time of it.
Oh.
And it was like, no one was making me like, I wasn't going to go to CVS. Like, yeah. I'm not going to, if they could DoorDash it, I may yeah. have gotten it.
Hell yeah. Like, the best time.
I had no real time. Reason to. I had no reason not to, I suppose, but it was just like, I just never got around to it.
Also in Kerrville, everybody's like, you fucking vaccinated motherfucker. Yeah, like outside of the CVS, like you going to get vaccinated? No, I'm going to get a Sprite, bro. Like, chill.
Get out of here, you vaxxer.
Yeah.
With the hard R.
With the hard R.
Relax, you vaxxers.
In Kerrville. Yeah. Dude, damn. He's one of the lucky ones. That's cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's interesting.
You think...
I've gotten COVID 3 times. So.
Did you?
And that's it, right?
That's all.
Yeah, for as much as you go out,
which,
you know?
Yeah.
Which is cool because I've gotten COVID 3 times and I got the vaccination, so fuck that.
And it didn't kill you. That's insane.
Probably because I got it. Maybe that's
dude, fun. CVS just fucking sent me a message. They know.
Wow. What does it say? Get your seventh vax. Get your seventh booster.
That's crazy.
What does it say?
That my birth control is ready for pickup.
Oh, bro. Because we were just talking about birth control. So in a minute, crazy. CVS is going to be... And by the way, while you're getting your birth control... Get your booster.
Get your Johnson & Johnson booster
hey,
shot.
Hey, Jesus wow. Christ. That's crazy. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, man. And Fauci's getting grilled now.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you saw that, bro?
Yeah. I thought that was old. When you sent that, I thought that was old.
It was that week. Yeah,
but is he still getting grilled?
Is it done?
I think it's closed already.
So what are they doing? Like they're bringing them up and then they're just like, hey, we're just going to give you a bunch of shit or like we're investigating to see if you did crimes or what?
Is it CHR?
I know you know, Warren.
No, yeah, there's no, yeah.
There's no point to it just to get them in front?
There's no H. Oh, what's the point of grilling? I don't know. Dude, they never want to hold anyone accountable for real things. Like it's... Maybe he did some bad things.
Oh, they do. He's doing it for the soundbite.
There it says Fauci testifies on the origins.
Down. Hey, man, we need some soundbites from you. Yeah, like, right you there. Made a few $1 million. Now we need some soundbites. You mind if we get you up there and just look stupid? Just look dumb. But the dude behind him looked even better. Did you see the guy behind him? When he's like, Fauci's like, yeah, well, my family's been threatened. People are threatening to kill us.
Oh, no.
There's a guy behind him. He's like, the guy behind Fauci. There's no H in Fauci.
No H.
Where's your favorite place to perform at, Warren? While we're looking up for this
Yeah, here in San Antonio, I guess. We got Blind Tiger in the station and The station's cool.
Have you done LOL yet?
I've done LOL. I've done the big room for Raul a couple of times on that, on his Revolver show.
Ooh, when we went, it was in the small room.
Yeah, I've done that Revolver show three times now, and twice it was in the big room, one time it was in the small room, and I think it's just depending on how many tickets.
Yeah. So I was just going to say, maybe it depends on that. There he is. You can play him. You're doing so much better than Rich, though. I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I've been wanting to yell at you once.
Being asked today about the guy seated right behind Dr. Anthony Fauci during that heated hearing about the pandemic on Capitol Hill.
That guy right there with the pretty lips.
He kept mugging for the camera during the most serious moments, and wait till you hear who he turned out to be. Megan Alexander reports.
Death. Who let this guy in? A mugging mocking gestures as he sat right behind Dr. Anthony Fauci during yesterday's fiery congressional hearing.
The vast majority of Americans appreciate your work over the years.
Look what happens as Fauci speaks emotionally about threats to his family.
They've involved my wife and my three daughters.
Yeah, that guy's probably sending them.
Incredibly, the guy doing all that mugging is 30-year-old Brandon Fellows. And get this, he was released from federal prison just 2 weeks ago serving 3 years for his role in the January 6th attack.
Oh, they dug that up.
Here he is the background on this guy. Office in a bizarre disguise, smoking weed.
Yeah, that's definitely him. Find the most clothed man that was there. We're going to just pin it on him.
A Nazi.
By the way, I heard those fucking hot dogs suck.
The judge told him to grow up and tacked an extra 5 months on his sentence. He was later ordered out of the hearing, shouting that Fauci should be in prison.
Fauci, go on to prison. What is that? Do we need to listen to that? Okay.
He was escorted out.
Yeah. Okay, good.
There is uproar on social media. You'd think a convicted J6 terrorist would be banned for life by Capitol Police, one posted. And this, a seat right behind Dr. Fauci? How? Dr. Fauci is
asking the same question. What's
J6 stand for?
Somebody like that.
I think that's clever.
I think that's amazing.
J6.
I think that's amazing.
Yeah, I'm a fucking J6.
Isn't that Jet?
Isn't it J6? That's a G6. Yeah.
Hi, I'm like a J6.
Yeah, if you flew millionaire, you would know that, sir.
I want to fly. I want to take a train, man. Come on, luxury train.
What if I called you one day and was like, Warren?
Well, I'd say yes.
Meet me on Millionaire, sir.
I'd say
we're fucking going, bro. Yeah. What if I said we're going to Little St. James Island?
Ooh.
It's probably over now. It's probably a tourist attraction.
I saw a video where like people got onto the island. Like they were kind of filming.
Really?
It. Yeah.
And it's a desert.
It's like a small island.
I think Warren can pass off for a 17-year-old.
100%.
Right? Both of y'all could, actually.
Yes.
Y'all are a loophole on Epstein Island,
Yeah. But wait, let's go. But just to like investigative purposes, not to go blend in. And
little boys, come here.
Yeah. Where is that? Is that island part of like?
It's the Virgin Islands, right?
It's the Virgin Islands.
Which is
not
interesting.
Not anymore.
Dude, that should be a fucking movie. Like two young looking men, like they're fully grown men. Go
like
to
Harold and Kumar?
I've never seen that movie.
Me neither, but I imagine that's what it's about.
Harold
and they go to get trafficked.
Yeah.
They want to lose their virginity, so they go to get trafficked.
For the culture,
For the culture. For Ann Coulter.
For Ann Coulter.
Bro Trip 2. That's what it
is. Bro Trip 2?
Yeah.
There's no part one?
There's
a bro trip?
There was a road trip. Where it's a couple guys.
Oh, yeah.
And I believe the plot is that they're going on a road trip and they want to lose their virginity before college.
Road trip.
Well, I mean, like they may have other goals, but it's
with the dude with the funny nose, right?
DJ Qualls.
Yeah,
there's already a road trip beer pong. What? I missed
that one. Well, wasn't Euro Trip also supposed
road trip?
Yeah,
yeah. With
Tom Green, dude.
Wow. He's trying to feed the snake the mouse the whole time.
Tom Green was iconic in the 90s, right?
Yeah,
watch that. Freddy got finger.
Daddy, would you like some sausage?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Have you never seen it?
No.
You don't have.
Yeah. He was married to Drew Barrymore.
Tom Green's the best, dude.
He had one. Dude, that's like two pods in a row where you bring up Drew Barrymore. He has only one testy.
Okay, that's cool.
He lives in the woods now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He's off the grid.
In Canada, right?
Yeah, in a barn. He's starting a podcast
in the van down by the river.
It's cool. He's awesome.
Yeah, he really is.
Come a long way from my bum is on your lips. My bum is
on your lips. My bum is on your lips. And if you're lucky, you might just give it a little kiss.
That's Eminem.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Did you listen to the new Eminem song? Did you like it?
I did. I thought his album was dropping, but it's just a song.
I
know,
dude. I was really sad it wasn't a whole album. Do you like Eminem, Warren? You kind of have to, right?
Yeah. Yeah. No, he's...
Like, do all white people like Eminem?
They have to. No,
I mean,
have you ever met a white person that was like, I fucking hate Eminem? Like, God, he's not us.
Yes. Alonzo. I talked to Alonzo about this the other day.
Alonzo hates everybody. Though.
Alonzo said he doesn't feel like black people should be able to talk about Eminem music. Only white people should be able to critique it.
Can we call him and get Alonzo? His feedback on this? This is an interesting take.
Let me see if he's available.
Wow. What? Black people can't talk about Eminem?
Yeah.
You know what? I was listening to that song in the car, My Band, by D12. Yeah.
That sound. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, because Eminem, Mac Miller, Hoodie Allen, Asher Roth. And that's it. Those are the only good rappers.
I don't remember those last two. Good.
Wait,
ever?
Did
ever?
You say?
Yeah, ever.
Did you not,
ever.
Did you not say Mac Miller?
Yeah, he did. You said it third.
Oh, okay.
Second. Eminem. Well, I'll put Hoodie Allen on top. He's a goat. Well, actually, Macklemore too.
You know? Oh, no.
That was in there.
Really?
I did not like Macklemore.
Nice with it. Who's Hoodie Allen, though?
Hoodie Allen?
Yeah. No, I know Woody Allen.
Hoodie Allen. I don't know.
This guy?
Yeah.
Let's hear his shit.
Hold on. What's
your favorite Hoodie Allen?
Alonzo.
He had a moment.
You got Alonzo?
Yeah.
Interesting. You want a Bluetooth in? Or you just want to put him here?
Yeah. Alonzo. Alonzo. Yeah, what's
up, man? You got a speaker.
Oh, I got to put you on speaker. I was telling the guys we were talking about Eminem right now.
You want to hear my Eminem take, right?
Yeah. 100%. You must be watching.
Yeah, 1 second. Let me pull my notes because I'm fucking. It's so funny. I hit applause like way more than I think I do. What was it about Eminem? I was drunk as shit too. But what it was is because I saw. I think it was Q Ugenti or whatever. I don't know how you pronounce the dude's name, but he's like a local comedian. He was saying, "Oh, Eminem fell off." And what it just made me think is you know, that conversation that black people were having like a couple weeks ago during the whole Kendrick and Drake
beat. All black people or all black people were
fucking thought. Just let me finish the thought, then you can tear it up. But yeah, well, here's the point: is that black people were saying that Kendrick and Drake is Drake black enough? And they're also saying that the only people that can have this conversation are black people. White people can't be having this conversation. Like, nobody else can be having this conversation except for other black people if Drake is black enough. You know, so that was my thing. It's like, yeah, I think the point was it was a conversation just among black people. And I think that's the feeling I have about did Eminem fall off. I think that it's a conversation that should only be had amongst white people. You know, I think black people need to sit down for this one, you know, and let white people have the decision. We'll let you know if Eminem has fallen off and when he fell off. And the answer is yes, Eminem has fallen off, but he fell off like years ago. So it's really not really the question there. But what was my other note? Because I thought I kind of tied it up here. What was it? It was the question becomes Eminem's influence as an artist. You know what I mean? Has that fallen off and stuff like that? Because when it comes to financial success, that's what most black people usually, measure with relevancy. You know, it's like, oh, this person's selling more. This person's, this person's more culturally relevant. You know, well, Eminem's obviously the most, highest selling, rap artists, and then, one of the highest selling music artists, solo artists, especially, so he's already has that. And then he just talks about what was Eminem's cultural impact. I mean, I don't know. I think the fact that we're even having that conversation still speaks to, I don't think it's fallen off there necessarily. But him making music that's really resonating, like in the mainstream, you know, I don't think that's really been a conversation for a while. Even with the whole Godzilla song, I think that was a
he went number two on the charts.
Are you just going to filibuster, or are you going to get to a stopping point?
That's it. That was it.
Cool. Thank you. That was our resident hip-hop correspondent, Alonzo Cantu.
Yeah, exactly. That was my point. That's the point I was about to make, right? So if you're going to ask for somebody's opinion on hip-hop, are you going to ask white people or are you going to ask black people?
I'm going to ask Alonzo Cantu going forward.
Because he has notes?
He took notes, dude.
You can't ask somebody on their opinion on hip-hop, even if they're white or black. You're going to ask black people for their opinion. If somebody's done.
I mean, I'm on a show with a black guy, so.
Right?
So yeah. Who's in the studio? Who's your guys?
We got Warren Greed, and he's actually promoting your whack ass podcast today.
What's up, dude?
Yeah, we had him
hostage. they're trying their.
We had him turn his shirt inside out. It was an Ernest Goes to Damascus shirt.
Is he wearing that right now?
Yeah, but it's inside out.
Oh, either way. Because I saw Warren wearing his, and he's so big that it makes the shirt look small. So I got a Warren size one on. The
yeah, it now. Shrunk. It I think this is a larger medium, and it shrunk.
All right, Alonzo. Well, thank you for calling in, man.
Yeah, man. Thanks for calling me. Have a great one. Yeah.
Good luck turning into the BFR podcast.
He's trying, dude. Let him.
BFR.
He's funny. He is a really funny fucking guy, though.
I think that's racist.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that was extremely racist.
Hey, he's
been. But it was valid.
Yeah.
It was valid. I did see you nodding your head. Yeah. Yes, quite a bit. It's like this guy's in agreement.
I liked Houdini.
It was a pretty good song.
I did not like it the first time.
It was not what he's been doing with his raps.
He really went back to old school.
Yeah.
When I heard it, I was like, oh, no. Like when I first heard it, I was happy for it. I thought it was going to be him rapping in some tricky fucking words. That's why it was called Houdini.
Yeah.
And then I was like, fuck. And then I listened to it again.
Yeah.
And again and again and again. I was like, okay.
Does he plan on releasing an album?
Yeah, it's called The Death of Slim Shady.
Oh, cool. And that's it?
I think that's what he's doing, wrapping it up.
He's going to kill himself.
That would be epic, dude.
At the end of it,
that's how I want to go.
The day the album drops, just kills himself.
In a car, off a bridge.
Oh, with a chick in the fucking, that would be even a pregnant
with Kim in the fucking trunk,
dude. He would just like make
and Haley in the passenger seat. She just got married,
dude. That would wrap up his whole career perfectly.
100%. Yeah,
would think
wrap
about,
up. Yeah,
that's a good pun.
Solid.
The big controversy is over the Megan Thee Stallion line.
Oh yeah,
the what?
The Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah.
Can you pull up the Megan Thee Stallion Eminem?
Thank you. You're here to work, woman.
Dude, supposedly there was a leak of Meg getting...
I heard, but then I kept seeing how it was not impressive, so I didn't check.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh,
we can check if you want.
Nah,
right. Also, we can check up on our AI girlfriend.
I think
Faces Blacklash.
Blacklash?
It is Blacklash, because only the blacks are mad at this. I'm kind of cool with it.
But then to Bean's point, have you heard the song Kim? That's like way worse than anything he says in the song.
Yeah.
Have you seen Gen Z react to Kim?
Uh-uh.
I want to watch that now.
There's TikTok videos. No, the song Kim.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I got to see that.
Yes, which is super fucking clever. If I was to ask for Megan Thee Stallion, if she would collab with me, would I really have a shot at a feat?
That is fucking solid.
That's just a good joke.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
I love how NBC went and said feat is short for feature.
Well, it is news for white people.
I don't get it.
This isn't BET, guys. Come on.
Like a D.
Tory Lanez got a 10-year sentence.
Oh,
you didn't know that?
Yeah.
I didn't know. Dude's in fucking prison right now.
He should not be in jail right now.
Nah.
Like, so that's what I want to know about black people, right? Do they want me to be enraged about this lyric, or should I be enraged about Tory Lanez shooting her, or should I be enraged that the justice system gave him 10 years?
Do you really care what they want?
No, Beans, I don't.
I know.
Fuck.
Yeah. What were we going to listen to?
Hoodie Allen.
Oh, Gen Z.
Hoodie Allen too, but Gen Z's response or Gen Z's reaction to To what? To, Kim lyrics.
Yeah, Gen Z reaction.
But don't forget, I want to hear Hoodie Allen. What's your favorite Hoodie Allen song?
No Interruption.
We had Jay Allen.
I actually haven't listened to Hoodie Allen in a long time. Because like he kind of had a moment there in like the mid-2000s, 2010s.
Really? What's his name? Hey, like Common did? Or hey, what's his name?
Yeah, hey, I haven't heard that song. He had his album Happy Camper, I think. He had Happy Cancer. Happy Camper and All American, I think, were like kind of his moment.
Oh, did you say Asher Roth in your top?
He did. I don't even know who that is either.
Yes. What?
He made he made like, one.
Why not
song,
Jack Harlow?
I know. Yeah. Oh, Jack Harlow. Oh, damn. Well, he's basically black, so
he does have like black people
really?
Hair.
Really?
I don't really like Jack Harlow, dude.
Really? Yeah. That one song is dope.
I love it.
I bought into Jack Harlow and then I was like, fuck yeah. And then I heard his whole album and it sucked.
Wow.
It was like he had two good songs.
But that one song is dope.
Which one? Dua Lipa?
No.
I want to do more than with her.
Change. You can't turn me down. You can whip your loving on me, baby. Whip your loving on me.
I'm vanilla. Oh, we're not going
to. I'm vanilla, baby. I choke you, but I ain't no killer, baby.
You don't know that part, right?
I say killer with an ER. I ain't no killer. Oh, I like that. Yeah, I am not a killer, baby. Let's see Gen Z react to Kim. Do we have it or not?
Probably one of those.
And then I want to know if Warren Greed's voting for Trump or not.
What? I don't know which one to click.
Right? The first one. Oh, the second one is actually more views.
Yeah.
Oh, but I'm glad to be back like
Oh, that's Houdini.
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever.
Yeah, I want to hear from the black people.
Right there.
I can't rap about being broke no more. They say I can't rap about coke no more.
Slut, think I won't choke no horn to the vocal cords. I'm working the throat no more. These motherfuckers are thinking I'm playing. Thinking I'm saying this shit because I'm thinking it just to be saying it. Put your hands down, bitch. I ain't gonna shoot you. I'ma pull through this pull and put it through you. Shut up, slut. You're causing too much chaos. So bend over and take it like a slut. Okay, ma? Oh, now he's raping his own mother.
This is
an so broken and we gave him the wrong
covers. I get it.
That's how it is, though.
Because he used to, you know, rap used to be real.
Imagine that.
It used to be real.
Imagine that song coming out
today. You want to beat women and kill gay people.
No, you don't. You want to hear about it. You don't want to do it. Yeah, like, yeah. I've never done that. But I loved hearing about it.
Yeah.
What I mean?
Like I always thought like, man, this dude really loved his daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like he's going to kill this bitch.
He prioritized his daughter over this crazy bitch because he knew what was in store for his daughter. Being raised by a crazy bitch, you're going to raise another crazy bitch. But if I kill her and I'm less crazy.
Amen, right? Beans. Talk that shit, baby. Rational mind, baby.
Like, come on. It sounds crazy, right? It sounds like I'm killing somebody. That's what it sounds like. But I'm dealing with a problem. That's what that is.
I can't talk to my mother, so I talk to my diary.
Yeah, 100%. But then again, what listens more?
With it today,
my diary listens to me. My diary listens to me. My mom doesn't. She acts like she does, but she really doesn't.
Fuck no, dude. We got to kill that bitch. Bust that cap in mama's bootay.
If I ask my diary, what did I write yesterday? I flip to the pages of yesterday and it remembers everything I said.
I was going
to
kill mom.
Not my mom.
Wasn't going to. Yeah, mom. You're not killing your own mom. You're killing her mom.
I'll kill both moms. I'm gonna kill both.
Okay, so here this is all backlash to the backlash of the reaction.
Oh, it's right. That one.
Where
it's
are the actual
the
reactions?
And that's the thing about the fucking media, man. It's all
Remember those black guys?
There's always a few people.
Gen Z reacting. Two Eminem.
No magic and here go my last chick. I'm about to say abracadabra. I'm gonna be rabbit up out of my hat. I'm about to relapse and I bet you that you won't know how to react. But I look at this cuss. I don't doubt to be that as I begin to fucking devour the track and you backpedal. That is a cowardly act like a Saudi attack when the time is coming.
Damn!
They always gotta leave the room.
They do, dude. It's because they can't stand the fact that a white man has perfected that craft. So they're like, I'm out.
And I didn't mean to say they.
We meant they, them.
Yeah. I want to be very clear. By they, I meant black
people. The reviewers.
Oh, shit.
There's no reactions.
There's probably just a few people who were mad about it, and then it's the jump on to those people, and that's the problem with the internet. You
got
it
right. And we got, and the telephone game got us acting like there's a bunch of people talking about the song Kim.
Why Eminem is canceled by Gen Z?
Oh, hold on.
Why is Kim Jong Un here?
More Gen Z. More mad about Eminem than
Hi Ro.
Hi Ro.
That's your guy. He was running train?
Yeah, he run train long
he
time.
Run train long time. Oh, because his name is Ken.
And now we're getting Megabus ads. Fucking amazing, bro.
He run train. That also sounds like an Asian name.
Let's go listen to
Hoodie. Run
he run train.
He run Who? Train. This he run train. My name is Hiro. This is my friend. He run train.
Oh,
no interruption. No interruption.
This is.
Is that him?
This was the first. Yeah, that is Hoodie Allen. No, it's some bridge.
Bridge.
Because he's British. I like that. This was my introduction to rap. So I could actually understand.
All American. First team, bitch. Yeah. I got a fake ID and a checklist. It goes, never meet a girl on Craigslist. And never spend your money on a necklace. 3 square meals, homie, gotta have breakfast. Real shit, she be paying for the date. I be on my Will Smith, enemy estate. Keep my friends close, keep my enemies away. Like they on repellent, they so jealous. I'ma do shit to just piss them off. Say you never heard me, it's yo lost. They biting on my freestyles. They tell me make my money frontin' on that weed style. I tell them I be too old for it. And I gave my brother my ID. She independent, bet these bitches never find me. I hope they don't find him though. Cause they be knocking on my door, now they looking through my window. Tell me what you really want from me. Point blank, no discussion. Close mouth, ow. I'll give it to you, no interruption. And tell me one time that you want me. I promise that I won't say nothing. Shut it up. I'll give it to you, no interruption. And you're home, and you're home. Oh, on the phone,
get it, Warren.
On the phone, all alone. I'll give it to you, no interruption.
Gang.
On the couch.
Time in the place of the function. I'll
give it to you, no interruption.
Talking money.
Is he talking about sex?
Man. No.
Like a
broadcast.
The game, but I'd rather get the best, so we're gonna get a strike.
All day. But, brand new kicks.
Really?
I've been out of Payless. Do it on my first.
This was actually really good.
It was solid.
I thought he was gonna be more like a double. You know what I mean?
No.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Like Suicide Boys?
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh, for sure.
Or Logic?
I hate Logic. At least half of him, for sure.
Dude.
No, but like those like British rappers that like just like, yeah.
You
yeah.
obviously never wanted to kill yourself.
Oh. Yeah, I don't like Logic, dude.
Really? Even that one song he made? It's like, I've been on the low. I've been taking my time.
No, I also don't like his face.
Like, his face.
I love the Asher Roth. There it is.
I love this song.
Zang going out so catchy. Like a sucker, no way.
I'm nice right now.
Oh, this is what you thought it was going to be.
I feel good.
No.
If you have a drink,
I like Asher
would you
Roth.
Please put it in the air?
The only song I've known.
Me
that
too.
That party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I danced my face off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my drink and smoke my phone. But my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I wanna go to college for the rest of my life. Sip Bankers Club and drink Miller Lite. On Thursday and Tuesday night ice.
What happened
and I
to him?
Can get pizza, a dollar a slice. So
fentanyl?
Fill up my cup.
No, he's still alive.
It wasn't fentanyl?
Dude.
Oh, wow.
What happened to Asher Roth? Like, he did he not have like the hits to
He's working on an album.
And hosting dance parties.
Why do white people take so long to put on new albums? Hair.
Because they ain't never getting no respect in this game, guys.
Oh, is that what it is?
They've been trying to keep us down.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That and they probably make wise investments with their money.
So they don't need to put out albums.
Not as good as Chameleon Air, dude.
Oh, really?
Yeah, dude.
What's his net worth?
What's Chameleon Air's net worth? But he invested into Silicon Valley.
Wow. Hey, you don't need to leave the tabs open anymore because we're recording on OBS.
So you could close
that them. Was old school shit.
You were way nicer to her about that than you were to me.
Oh, yeah, yeah. This
well, because we had our guest calling you out on it.
$50 million bucks. That's not bad. $50 million. That's not bad. Dang. It's pretty good because he hasn't put it out an album in forever. Like, right?
Since 2010?
Yeah. But like
maybe
the last song, the best song, I mean, the song that Ride Don't Dirty. Blame Us for Fiction.
That was way before that, too.
Big house is candy paint and big swing.
Yeah, I'd rather be rich and
don't call my page because my money gets jealous. I grew up with that dude.
Yeah?
Yeah. He doesn't remember me, but I remember.
Him and
Paul Wall?
Paul Wall, yeah.
You didn't put Paul Wall in your white rapper list.
No, I...
Because you're not from Texas, right?
I'm not from Texas.
You don't see it.
Young Gravy. He's from Minnesota.
Sounds like somebody I'd like.
Yeah. Mm.
Pretty good.
Rich loves himself some Young Gravy.
Let's hear Young Gravy.
On some chicken.
Mr. Clean. That's what
yeah, I feel like
want.
I'm going to make him hungry right now, but we're
some KFC gravy?
Oh, Young Gravy.
Yeah. Would you, was it Whataburger or KFC gravy better? Or
different
Bill Miller's?
Gravy, buddy.
Oh, really? Bill Miller's and Whataburger?
Bill Miller's.
Oh,
Bill Miller Ranch, though.
I prefer Whataburger biscuits and gravy.
Mm-hmm. Damn.
Right? That's just smack,
it's
boy.
Literally baked flour and liquid flour together. That's all biscuits and gravy is. It's not.
Oh, thank you. Our resident fucking food expert.
Wow. Did you know flour is flammable? Dude, no. I was watching
what happened.
I was watching. Do you all ever watch Deadliest Catch? Dude, that's one of my favorite shows ever.
Is that what you were watching when we came in?
Yeah. Have you ever watched it?
You never seen it?
You know, on some white boy shit. Yeah, you got to, right?
He was in an episode.
He tried. Yeah, he tried it once.
I was the catch, you know?
And I'm pretty fucking deadly. Dude, so they were going to surprise.
People also search for just other two other white rappers.
Is that Tony Hinchcliffe? That first one? Yeah.
They were going to surprise this guy for his 50th birthday. And they were like, we're going to fucking smash like an 18-pack of eggs on his head. And then somebody's going to throw a whole bunch of fucking flour on his head. But they had these lights, these sodium lights, right?
Oh, shit.
And so they did it and they fucking got all this flour everywhere. And then you see just this fucking ball of flames. And the dude that's 50 years old and it's his birthday is fucking goes up in flames, dude.
Screaming free Palestine.
Yeah. It's funny because I was like, Jack his Miles, come see this surprise. It's going to be funny, right? It's going to be fucking hilarious.
No.
And then I'm like, oh no, guys, don't watch this. This fucking guy's burning alive.
That was your dad's this weekend. Well,
we saw a man burn alive, Mom.
He told us it was a surprise.
It was wild, dude. Yeah.
Dude, what the fuck?
Yeah, it's crazy. I wish we could see that part. It was nuts. And he was fine afterwards. He's a crazy dude. But anyway, Young Gravy.
Yeah, you want to do
what
Mr. Clean.
Lil Dicky.
What about Lil Dicky?
I love Lil Dicky.
It's so many great white rappers. You guys. No, this guy's from Rochester, Minnesota, which is right near where I'm from, and he's taken off on the TikToks lately.
Wait, do I wait for Beansy?
Nah, just play it. Fuck Beans.
You should have been here.
He'll never understand.
Gravy.
Oh yeah, I have heard this song.
Gravy.
I like it.
Hey, I already like it.
Mr. Simon.
Gravy.
Bring me a dream.
Bum, bum, bum. Gravy.
Make him the cutest that I've ever seen.
Bum, 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 bum.
Give him two lips like roses and clover.
Bum, bum, bum.
Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over.
Gravy make a splash like Pippin. Shit, that's nothing.
Splash.
Everybody call me Big Pimpin'. No, I ain't bluffing. I'm with your mom in the kitchen, making blueberry muffins.
State muffins. He's giving me little dicky vibes.
Cause he'll bitch all the stuffing. Mr. Clean. Gravy, why you flow so mean? Mr. Clean. Pull up with my whole damn team. Mr. Clean. Mr. Clean.
I think if you have a certain amount of money, you don't need a beard. Mr. You know?
Clean. Gravy, he be clean like Windex. Just hit your mind with my index. And your bitch look like a pinhead. All my haters, they be skinheads. Pissed off as a wife, as a sister. Young Gravy just kissed. Hot damn. Pull up on the scene. Cause a wet dream, I might need a summer ring. If you got the beef, I turn your ass to smell the rings. Your bitch looking scary, I thought it was Halloween. Gravy, he be clean like some fucking Listerine. But I smooth it out like a jar of Vaseline.
Rachel McAdams by Lil Dicky.
Okay, he doesn't have to make it look this easy, though.
Right?
You know, he's not that great, but it's a good.
Rachel McAdams by Lil Dicky.
He makes it look so easy, and you're not, like, you're good, but, like, you're making it look easy. That's funny.
I never know with, you guys got me for the right wrong there. Rap episode.
Just for the record, I'm showing up next week in a white cotton robe.
You don't even care about me.
I love Lil Dicky.
Tell me right? Why I care about you. This ain't the movies, but I think that you're the one. Rachel, let me be your Mr. McAdams. Rachel, they gon' call me Mr. McAdams. I take your name, girl, facts. It's insanely far-fetched. I ain't playing, why you think I've been rapping to be Mr. McAdams, say yes. Don't lie to me, don't lie to me, don't lie. You think I'm fucking sick. You think I lost my shit. You think I'm weird AF. But that endearing freckle up on your chin is too much. I got a freckle on my face, too. I know you've dated Taylor Kitsch. And I know you've seen Ryan Gosling's dick. Oh, girl, I don't know it all, girl. I just wanna take you to a ball, have a ball, girl. Valet will call me Mr. McAdams. Rachel, they gon' call me Mr. McAdams. I take your name,
girl, facts.
It's insanely far-fetched. I ain't playing, why you think I've been rapping to be Mr. McAdams, say yes.
Are you a blonde or brunette? You pull them both off like socks in a bed. Notebook even had a little bit of red. I don't know why I'm telling you about your hair. You would know best, you was there, it's your hair. Girl, I confess that I suck dick. Not suck dick, but gave head. I'm just bad at doing this shit. Girl, just let me prove that I'm him. Heard you're 5'4", I bet you ain't even know that's my ideal height. I'm 6 foot, 5'11", I'm 5'10", friends here. And I got fans too, so I can relate to this being off-putting. Sorry. But I just know you'd like what I could give. Swear. Imagine guac without no chips. Imagine me up at your door, out of nowhere. What would you say? What would we do? Probably be weird. Too much build-up, too much press. Or maybe we would fight like rabbits. Maybe I'm your Brad Pitt. Fuck Brad Pitt, don't think about him. Rachel, they gon' call me Mr. McAdams.
I swear he just writes songs so that we can meet these people.
Okay, maybe white people just need to change the name of the genre that they're doing.
Oh, I like this idea.
Yeah.
What would you call it?
Crack 'em.
I don't know. Crack hop?
Cracker rapper.
Cracker hop.
Rapper cracker.
Well, it's, well, what would you call it?
Well, rap is
unfair.
Rap is rhythm and poetry.
Okay. Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Damn. Wow.
You're not black.
Minority
enough.
Over here.
I mean, he's obviously studied. He's white.
Yeah. So I would just call it good rap. That's what I call rap.
Look at Kanye in the back. He's like, I fucking love it.
Rap, but good. That's what rap
is. He started a porn company. Kanye.
Oh yeah, I heard about
that. Is it called good porn?
And they play it in
he's
the
like, good rap. Better rap.
Better rap.
Best rap.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Right? But that, it's different. It's black rap is different from white rap. I don't think, maybe, what's his name?
It's Paul Wall.
Bubba Sparks.
Oh no.
No.
Mm-mm.
That wasn't even close to being black.
Go take Paul Wall.
But you didn't like Bubba Sparks?
Mm-mm.
Really?
Mm-mm.
It's going to get ugly?
Mm-mm.
What about like Asian that? Rappers? You know, we
no, those, get the those Asian are not rappers. Real.
Oh, what was real. His name?
Rich, what Asian Jin? Rapper?
Jin? Rich Brian? Fucking Joji doesn't really, I mean, he does more R&B, but back MC when he Jin. Was a pink guy.
No.
Rich Brian.
No.
Dumbfounded?
It's like Asian porn. No, I can't get down with that.
Yeah, I can't. Group. I can't get in.
No. It's boring.
You're fucking me harder. Fucking me, Mr. Rich.
That's Korean porn.
It's Asian.
But that's all they do. It's
yeah.
Oh, you fucking hard me.
Yeah, you're not watching the right one.
Yeah, it's very bad.
I'll send you some links in the BFR chat.
How are you watching it?
Please
banned it.
Don't.
It's not
with ExpressVPN.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're sponsored by them. Jesus.
Come on, bro.
I like that that girl's name is Ramen Girl.
Oh my God.
So it's not even racist if you tell her that. You're just a little ramen girl. Like, can you call fucking Asians ramen people now?
Ramenese?
Yeah, you fucking Ramenese.
Have you ever slept with an Asian?
No.
Mike Shinoda.
Have you ever slept with an Asian?
It's a Bangladesh count.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Is Bangladesh in Asia?
Yes. Yeah.
Were you in the military?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really? No. Did you pay for it?
No.
Did you ever go to Japan?
She did. No.
She paid for it in the end.
I was in the National Guard. I was never deployed.
Oh, you weren't really.
Yeah, I wasn't really.
My bad.
Thank you for your service.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you anyway. Yeah. Is that what you tell people in the National Guard? Hey, thank you anyway.
Yeah, thanks for trying.
Thank you for your kind of service.
Everyone's like, you signed up, man. I'm like, okay.
Appreciate you.
I went to college for free. That's nice.
Oh, what'd you major in? Fucking bitches.
Supposed to be history.
Oh.
But then I finished with a just basic university studies degree.
Mm. So
dropped down and moved here, and then I finished online. And
what do you like about San Antonio?
Oh, dude. I like that I can leave soon.
Yeah.
No. San Antonio's honestly a pretty cool. They have a lot of parks. I'm like surprised about the amount of
parks.
The amount of greenway, the amount of
really with all the Mexicans here?
Public area. I mean, it'd be nice if it was public area for me, yeah. But like, you know. I'll let anyone there, I guess.
Oh, Lil Tay.
Mm-hmm. That's the only rapper I know.
That was some crazy shit. Remember?
She thought she was dead?
Yeah. Her dad posted she was dead or some shit.
Like her brother.
Her brother?
I don't know.
She looks like the drummer from Hanson back in the day.
That's
why. Solid pun.
She looks like someone from Lords of Dogtown.
Oh.
Like that.
She looks like someone you'll find in Beans' attic.
Why? She's 14.
He doesn't like Asians.
Oh, yeah. Forget it. Never mind, Beans. My bad. I was going with the age and not the ethnicity.
The wrong filter.
Wow. This is wrong. This is not cool.
Lil Tay, not dead.
You ever sign up for Kill Tony?
I feel like I'm babysitting Lil Tay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A couple times, yeah.
Damn.
They haven't pulled you?
Just a couple?
Yeah, because you know you got to drive out to Austin to maybe get on, and then now it's awful. The last time I signed up, they moved the waiting location to that bar like that's like across the street, and the bar is so tiny. It's the word. It's just
poor choices.
Poor choices. It was a poor choice for a bar,
and it's a poor choice for a name like to be waiting at because half of them are probably like, dude, what the fuck am I doing here? Why the fuck did I come here? You know, I made a poor choice. You know what? I'm gonna fucking leave.
I met someone at the last time I signed up. He moved from Maryland to Austin to pursue comedy. I'm like, oh, that's cool. How long have you been doing? He said a week. He said a week, and he moved to Austin to do comedy.
That is fucking crazy.
That's he's having a manic episode.
Yeah, that or somebody was. People in his ear to all say, oh, you're great. You're funny. You're hilarious.
No.
There's not an amount of people that could tell me that I'm funny for me to go to fucking Austin.
Ooh, yeah, that's crazy. He's having an episode.
Austin's a hard scene to like break into. Like it's so oversaturated. Like if you're moving there and you're already funny and like you can prove that you're funny. But if you're a weekend, you're trying to get funny and like you're fighting the 10,000 other people who did the same thing as you.
Is there a difference how you're received there versus here?
I don't know. I don't know how I'm received there. I would say I'm just like not received there because like people don't know who I am. Like there's a lot of people. I don't know how I'm received here. I think the jokes work the same if they work. If they work, they work. If they don't, they don't. I would go more if like, I would like to live close to Austin. Like, if I could start meeting people, I hate going, I hate being in new places. I don't know.
That'd be cool to, like, if it, live in between.
New Braunfels?
Yeah. San Marcos.
San Marcos, New Braunfels area.
Kyle.
Kyle.
Pflugerville.
It's a cool guy.
Round Rock.
Pflugerville.
That's north.
Yeah, that's beyond. So now you're in between Waco and Austin.
Oh, even better.
I would want to live in one or the other. I don't know. Because if you're living in, like, New Braunfels, it's nice because you can, like, you're equidistant away, but then you're still half hour away from either one of them.
It's
opposed to... You know, now living in San Antonio, like, I'm actually in the city now. It's nice. Yeah. You can get to places within 10 minutes opposed to way out here in the burbs. You got to drive 20.
And Nieto's doing shows out there every fucking weekend in the Braunfels.
Who?
Josh
Nieto. You know him?
No. Mexican really? Dude?
Yeah.
No. He's white.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. He looks white.
He's just trying to blend in, so he calls himself Josh Nieto.
Joshua J.
Well, it's like...
It's really Joshua Joshua Smith. Sorry, Hernandez.
I mean, it's like Alonzo Cantu.
Yeah, he's not really...
What the hell's up
us.
With that?
Yeah, we wouldn't take him.
I don't think we claim him in the race.
No, track. If there was a race war, he'd be on y'all side. Nah, 100%.
He'd be with the blacks.
No.
He would be with the whites.
Kill, the blacks would kill him quick, he would especially lead, for what he just said about Eminem.
He would be leading them, for sure.
I think we would take King Kwazi.
I'm going to say it.
That means that you're calling black people dumb.
Well, that's a pretty sick burn towards Alonzo. That's some layers to that one.
Yeah, I have to.
I would draft King Kwazi onto Team Mexicans.
Yeah. Kwazi would be on our side.
Yeah.
I think so.
Is he half Mexican?
No. He's fully black. It's probably the blackest person I've seen. But I feel like he's got some Mexican in him, you know?
Yeah, he did.
Whoa.
Just kidding, Kwazi. I didn't put any Mexican in you. No. I definitely didn't do that.
Ooh, but then they would also have Davy Jacks, dude.
The blacks?
The whites.
The whites. Yeah, that's not fair. He's a cheat code.
Mm-hmm. And Justin.
Yeah.
Justin's Mexican.
Dude, did you see that video?
It shocked me.
I thought he was white.
Yeah, no, he's...
Okay, he's cool, because that threw me off. I was like, that guy's got to be fucking Mexican. Yeah. But his last name's Governor?
Yeah, I thought that was a white.
It's Spanish.
It's Spanish. Yeah. So he's Spanish.
His family's Governor? From Mexico.
Oh. Yeah. Did you see the video that he recorded?
I'm pretty sure it's Spanish.
It was an almost fight.
Yeah.
E at the end.
It was a lot going on in that video, though.
1-0.
Yeah, 1-0. 1-0. Sorry.
Old Italian.
Oh, his last name means a rudder. A Dutch rudder.
We need to get him on.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, we need to get him on here. I still haven't watched where he was on fucking the Naked and Afraid. But go to what is it? All of SA? What is it? Fucking
As of SA. Or
As seen in SA. And on the Instagram.
Mr. McAdams.
I don't know how to use
Instagram. Just go to search.
On the left.
As seen.
Right. There it is.
There it is. First video.
You're so good. I'm glad to have you back.
Thanks.
Whatever.
Okay, we can get it.
You're the one moving your mouth.
All right, homie in a fucking full blown suit and some Stacey Adams, and then homie in a
some pants.
Betty, he's on a bike. He's on a bike.
Baby, he's on a bike.
He was on a bike. The dude in the suit.
Yeah.
I'm on that shit.
Is that Hyro?
Yeah.
So Hyro.
This is outside the station.
Right, I thought it was from here.
Take little.
Fuck your bike. Hey, shit.
I'm just filming.
Yeah,
that has to be an electric bike, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's what they're saying in the comments.
Looks like.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Ew, this is so cringe.
It's pretty fucking cringy, dude.
What happened? I don't get it.
Yeah, nothing happened.
Nothing ever happens.
Yeah.
The bike got the most action.
It's either that or they're shooting. It's not the in-between. The fighters are the women. Like, we saw that in Fiesta. Mm. Most of those fights that got caught on video were women. Right? And then the one instance where there was a men involved, it was a shooting.
Yeah, because dudes can't fight. Mm-mm. But they can shoot.
Yeah. Well, they shouldn't fight.
Mm-mm.
But they want to.
People should just do like the old fashioned. You just put them out in the street and have a fucking draw.
A duel?
Yeah.
Oh.
At high noon?
Yeah, dude. Like, hey, y'all want to really kill each other? This is the plan. Look.
Why did they do it at high noon?
I guess because the
sun wouldn't.
No shadows. Yeah. Like, no nobody sun. Gets an advantage.
Yeah. Wow.
You know. You have to know, right? Y'all made the rules.
Yeah, it's because that's when church gets out.
They,
church.
They wanted an audience.
Pray to God. Nobody's got sins. You can die now.
Confess, get it all off your chest, and then let's go.
Pretty sure mutual combat is still legal in Texas. You can't shoot, but like you can, if two guys are fighting, they can be like, no, this is fine. We're not going to press charges.
We got confirmation.
Yeah, I learned that on TikTok.
That's cool. Yeah.
Which,
that's great.
Which means it's true. That's
awesome. Yeah. Rich.
Don't tell me.
Just do it.
Hold on. Look at that sweet ass HTX sandwich though.
What is a what?
This? Yep. That looks delicioso.
It's not
going
to be it. Watch. Oh, that's it.
It is dude.
We'll be stopping by today before departing.
Why is that in a San Antonio thing?
Miko's shot chicken.
I kind of hate ranch. Lost me with the ranch.
You just run.
Same.
I hate ranch. Gross. Dude.
Is mutual combat still legal in the state of Texas?
Oh, yeah. That it is. You just can't shoot.
Yeah.
Oh. So fighting.
Yeah, yes. Texas is one of only two states that allow individuals to engage in a physical altercation if both consent to the fight. You just got to tell like a cop that's right there, like, hey, dude, this is mutual. We're cool.
Like if you both at the end say, nah, we're good with it. We're just fighting. The cop's not going to arrest you for, what assault? Is it called?
It would be assault.
But even if like a public disturbance or
yeah,
what
they
is
could it? Probably get you for public disturbance.
Oh, okay.
I think if you're roping other people in, and then it says, and then box without serious injuries. Like, yeah, if you break someone's arm, then maybe that's like aggravated.
What if they break their own arm?
That's, I mean, but that's tricky. That's logical because, like, it's like, cool, just do it until you know you fucking won. Don't take it too far. Like, that's great. We're going to let you fight the state of Texas.
They should let them shoot.
Right?
Though,
but once one of you wins, just stop.
Like the Cowboys did, dude, in the fucking Western movies.
Yeehaw.
Yeah, Cowboys haven't won in like 27 years, though.
Yes, that's back when the Western movies were still relevant.
That's when Tombstone came out.
But what about shooting each other?
Yeah.
Is there anywhere that it's legal to duel?
Duel with a gun.
Huh?
The U.S.
The U.S. in other countries.
Let's ask Kyle Rittenhouse. Yeah.
Hey, is that the one who his parents ended up going to prison? Or is it a different
school
shooter? No, Kyle Rittenhouse was the one that shot at the BLM rallies.
Oh, I thought it was a school shooter guy.
Or riots. I don't know how they classify those anymore.
Everything just says fights.
Take out
third one, the second one.
I don't think you can do it with a gun.
No, but take out Texas, say United States.
Yeah, in general.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. We got to make America great again.
Yeah, ever since then, this whole political correctness.
Ever since the Civil War, man, we've gone down.
All the good stuff's been taken away from us.
You heard it here first.
Guys,
is Greed a Jewish last name? Greed can't be a Jewish last
name,
right?
No, it's Scottish.
It's Scottish. Are there no Jews in Scotland?
No, we Saint Patrick drove. No, that's Ireland.
They were the snakes.
Yeah, but snakes? Well, the snakes were really the pagans, but also the Jews are thrown in there. Sure, why not?
So there wasn't really snakes. That was just a metaphor.
That was a metaphor for pagans.
Oh, what the fuck!
Wow.
Yeah.
What? A metaphor for what?
When St. Patrick drove out the snakes, it was driving out all the pagans.
Oh.
All the non-Catholics.
I thought it was real snakes this whole entire time.
Wow.
Is it because of that episode of The Simpsons?
Yes. Pest control. I was like, man, this dude's really good at this shit.
Dude, that's crazy.
Are you voting for Trump, Warren?
No. No.
Why? Because now he's a felon?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that why? Before you were? Like,
no. No. Like it. And then,
are you voting?
No, probably not. I voted 3 times last election and it didn't work out. No, I don't know. It's stupid. If I vote, I don't know if I'll vote. Maybe Jill Stein. I don't know if...
They should have Ben Stein run, right?
Isn't he dead?
No. The Clear Eye for the Queer Guy or something?
Oh, I thought he wrote the Ben Stein Bears.
Yeah, no.
Berenstain Bears.
Can you check if Ben Stein is dead? He can't be dead. I just had a dream of him the other day.
Bro, what kind of dream?
Oh, he's alive. No, he's dead.
Wow.
No.
No.
Oh, wait, he's alive.
Years old, bro.
He's as old as Biden, dude. He should run. He's
the speechwriter for Nixon or something.
Yeah, I know, dude. That's why I'm saying.
Gerald Ford.
And Gerald Ford, Rich.
So who do you think is going to win presidency?
I heard the backs are backing Trump now.
But who speaks for the blacks?
Joe Rogan. I heard it on Joe Rogan's podcast.
Definitely blacks got fucking Trump now.
Well, that's just because they want, they see him as radical change, which I think is just indicative of just where we're heading. Because like neither one's going to be neither candidate's really going to help their situation. Mm-hmm. You know, neither candidate's going to help any I'm trying not to sound any lower class, you know. It's like
they're not trying not to sound lower class.
No, but like they want
neither candidates really care.
Neither candidates care, but they're seeing Trump as at least radical change, which is I think not on paper, but like the view of him is like, yeah, he's kind of like this quote unquote outsider, but he's really just another Reagan, and like everyone since Reagan has just been a different version of Ronald Reagan, where it's tax cuts for the rich, corporate welfare in the name of trickle down economics, and never actually trickles down. And Biden and Obama and Trump, they're not going to change it. So what we need
is
to start mailing bombs.
Mailing bombs? Where are we going to mail them to?
I don't know. Just
Ukraine.
And anyone.
We're already doing that.
Oh, yeah. We are already doing it.
And Israel.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I don't like that we're supporting all these wars, dude.
But I felt better financially when he was in office. And I didn't ever want to vote for him, right? But was it because we were getting all those stimulus checks?
Like them stimulus.
And we were home more often.
Dude.
So we didn't have to spend. I mean, we were spending more. I think we were spending quite a bit, but maybe we weren't because we weren't out every day. And you know, you go out every day and you spend like $100. You're just fucking going out for 2 hours. You don't have kids. You have kids. You have a... No, you don't. It's just a joke. Damn it.
I have a niece.
Yeah. I was thinking about that. I was like, he said he's having a kid. Wait, is that just a joke? Right. It's part of the joke, right?
Yeah, it's part of the joke.
Okay, cool.
My sister's had it.
But when you have kids, you can't go out for 2 hours without spending at least $100, easy. Right? So maybe back when Trump was president, most of the time, was it most of the time that he was president? No, it wasn't even most of the time, though, right?
Lucky
that we were
just towards the end there.
Yeah, it was just towards the end. So why did it feel better financially when he was president?
Because inflation wasn't as bad as it is now.
Who's the cause of inflation?
Well, is it because we got all that money?
So much money into the system, now it's correcting itself, and that's what the inflation is. It's just barely starting to get under control, and that's still a
lot of it's still corporate greed now. Yeah. And there's been a lot of collusion.
Which is your last name. So like we have to ask that question. Like,
you're the expert.
What are y'all doing?
War and greed, man.
Yeah.
War and greed. That's
war and greed.
War and greed. Bars.
Yeah.
Bars. Fucking bars.
That's dude. A rap, man. I'm telling
you're
you.
Named after the simulation.
No, but
it's crazy. War and greed.
That did I will say the one good thing out of that Biden's doing is the FEC or the FTC. Lena Khan has been the most effective chairwoman of the Federal Trade
Commission. And what's she doing?
She's blocking.
Net neutrality is back.
Is that Lena Khan?
Mm-hmm. Does that have to do with the trans people?
No.
Yeah, because they got rid of it and she came back.
But they're like,
I wish they would get rid of the trans.
Trans fat?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're stopping non-competes. So mm-hmm. like, you know, mm-hmm. when you used to work at Jimmy John's, you used to have signed a non-compete. So you couldn't work at another sandwich shop for three years.
That's crazy.
Like, they're not enforcing those. She's blocking mergers. She's, you know, mm-hmm.
that's crazy.
She's doing good things. It's that, like,
and did Biden put her in place?
Yeah.
Oh.
Now, say how much Biden agrees with what she's doing. Like, I don't think it's Biden's top priority to be this corporate trust buster, but mm-hmm.
He's got people there that
he's doing.
That's what they want.
Well, that's one good thing.
It's one good thing.
I did feel way more ballin' when Trump was president, for sure.
Yeah, I did too.
I think that's
even without the
without the stimulus.
Like,
yeah,
it was cool because I was like, oh shit, there's an extra fucking whatever 1600 coming. That's cool. Like, but I'm not paycheck to paycheck right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but think of how much you were making then and how much it's increased between then and now, and versus what inflation is. That's why you felt more money back then, because
I was making less money back then.
Well, yeah,
but because I was in a different position,
right? But percentage wise, how much has your income increased?
Huh?
Percentage wise, how much has your income increased?
Because of what?
Like over time, just
Not like you made 50,000
back then, and now you're balling at 120,000 because you got a Tesla in your, mm-hmm. your driveway. That's obviously what you make.
But I live in a D.R. Horton home that everybody...
Do you ever plug your Tesla into something else?
What?
Yeah. I don't know. In my head, it was way better.
Did you get the Tesla insurance?
Yeah.
Oh, good job, dude.
Yeah, it is, but you got to be careful how you drive. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Special insurance for Teslas?
Yeah. Well, it's just, I guess Tesla... Dude, it seems like a monopoly. It really does seem like a monopoly because... I have to go to a Tesla super. I don't have to, right? I charge here, but Tesla supercharger, right? If I want to get the good charge, and I drive a lot if I want to get a quick charge. So you're locked down. You got to be on the app. That's how you pay for it. There's no fucking credit card machines at these charging stations. You got to get to that one. If you want to go to a different one, you got to buy a different adapter. So you're not going to do without all that, right? Mm-hmm. Then they're like, hey, Tesla insurance, so much less than Geico insurance, right? So come on over, get your Tesla insurance. And we'll sign you up super cheap, right? But then we're gonna charge you based on your driving. And we determine the fucking grade of your driving. Mm-hmm. And the settings of your car determine if you get these alerts. So, like, if you don't fucking set your shit to the right setting, dude, you could be... There's times where my car fucking is like, beep, beep, beep. You're about to hit somebody. I'm like, dude, I'm not about to hit somebody right now. That person's way a fucking head. Like, I'm good. But if you don't change your setting on your car, then that's registering as you almost colliding with somebody.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. And so your fucking score goes down. And it's like, so they have the monopoly on that shit. Like, Geico doesn't do that. Geico's like, I'm going to charge you fucking so much more, but drive.
Yeah. Like, well, some insurances have it. Like, you put an app on your phone and they do, like, give you discounts based on how you drive.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think, to your point, they can control it a little bit more than Progressive.
Yeah.
Would y'all smash Flow? That's from Progressive, right?
Do you Flow from Progressive?
Yeah.
Can
you pull up a picture?
There's been
of Flow?
Times where, like, I don't want to search for porn, dude.
And then, like, you just go to a Progressive commercial?
No, it's on. I'm like, might as well, dude. It's late.
Oh, yeah. Go to her full images. What happened?
Why does that have to zoom into her eye wrinkles?
The 18th.
No, not the one with that. Stop doing that. What? In her best light, not her.
AT&T chick is way better than Progressive.
So?
Lily? You fuck with Lily over
Flow? Yes.
Yeah, I do.
Wow.
I agree.
Okay.
Wow, what do you think, Warren?
Twice in 1 week.
Online sexual harassment.
That's exactly what we're doing right now. How Flow from Progressive helped AT&T's Lily after online sexual
harassment. Warren, do you have a professional job?
Yeah, I'm a consultant.
For Progressive?
Yeah. That's why I can't comment. No, I do IT auditing for
I'd rather fuck Jake from State Farm.
IT auditing?
Yeah.
Like, what are you auditing? The data?
We're auditing their process and making sure that the process is secure. There's like government compliance. When you have a public company, you have to make sure that
socks.
This socks area. Yeah. I was doing socks for a little bit. Now I'm just doing, I hate it.
What do you do for fun? Who's your inspiration to comedy? Well, answer both questions.
Well, I do comedy for fun. That's pretty much, just work and comedy. You know, that's pretty much what I do. And then,
do you do drugs?
Occasionally, you know.
Yeah. What's
your favorite drug?
I do ketamine therapy.
That's, really?
Yeah. Dude.
That's have you ever hung out with comedy. Alex Reyes?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Is that why?
No.
Is that how y'all met?
I started ketamine therapy when I first moved here. And then that like completely turned my life around, which is kind of what made me not necessarily want to do comedy, but I wanted to do something. Because that's like why, that's one of the reasons why I was so depressed is like I wasn't doing anything. And I couldn't do anything because I was so depressed. So then...
Oh, it's like I'm fat because I'm depressed and I eat because I'm fat or some shit. How do you say that?
I usually say it at night crying, but yeah. I eat because I'm unhappy. And I'm unhappy because I eat.
There you go.
It's a vicious cycle. And then you ketamine and then, and then.
Really?
Yeah. It's a,
Rox, would you ever try ketamine?
I don't know what it does.
Okay. What is it like? So what does it do? What is it like? Treatment one, what you immediately like, oh shit, something's happening. Because Alex is like, it helps you face your problems and deal with them. And
it's a dissociative. So it really just kind of puts your ego to sleep. So then you can kind of view your life. You can view it from a neutral perspective and be like, oh, this is what I'm doing.
Without judgment of whether good or bad, it's like this is what I'm dealing with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So like it was really after my second session because when you go to the clinics, they do
WebMD.
They do injections and they dose it up. So they titrate it where it's like a low dose. So the very first time I went, it was like 25 milligrams, which just kind of gives you like a little body high. You're not thinking too much. And the second one.
Does anybody jerk you off at this time? Or?
No, but you often... You often like kind of jerk yourself off a little bit, like not, really? Not like actually, but like
yeah, but the way you're feeling.
Usually, you'll kind of like put your hands down, cut down your pants. You can't actually do anything because like they use it as a anesthetic. But like you know, if you're ever dreaming, like or do you guys ever wake up and your hands down your pants? You're like, oh, no, I'm just feeling myself. No,
okay. No.
Well, that's what I do.
You wake up and your hands in your pants.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
just that takes a lot of effort.
Feeling it.
Wow.
No, it's great. It's
why do you think
but you're in a clinic?
Yeah, it's a clinic. It's a doctor.
And you get amnesia.
Relief from amnesia.
Relief from pain.
Relief from pain and
amnesia. Oh yeah, no memories. That's kind of true. Yeah.
Really? Well, oh, hold on.
Because they use it as a anesthetic still.
Oh look. It's also used for sexual assault.
No,
it helps you forget about it.
It helps you with PTSD too, because again, you can kind of see your problems and you can face them.
How do you see them?
You should try it, Rich.
I'm gonna try it.
What does that mean? You're gonna try it?
Mm-hmm.
Once I get, you come back and report.
Yeah,
it's covered by insurance.
By most insurance.
Some, yeah. Depending on the clinic, if you Clarisana, that's where I started. They stopped they stopped dealing with the insurance for a while, but now they're doing it again. It's still kind of expensive, even with the insurance. But
so your second treatment, did you come out of it like once you started feeling the effects? Did you come out of it like, okay, I got to take care of this. I got to go and do this. I know I got to knock this out. It's no problem anymore. I'm not tripping about it.
It was just kind of I realized that. I was in control of my own happiness and my own life. And it's like, you realize a lot of things. It's like things that you know, but like you then like get it and like, you like understand it. It's like, okay, this really isn't that hard to.
Does it help with anxiety?
Yeah, a little bit. I think that's maybe more, I'm definitely less anxious. But I'm still incredibly anxious, but I think it helps me, work on my anxiety. I don't think it's going to 100% cure it, but because that's like something you got to work on. It's something you got to.
Where do they inject it?
Your
butt?
No, your
arm. Oh, damn. Arm. That's, but not, you can, that's get, less fun.
You can also get IV, which right? is kind of cool.
In your K-hole. Okay. That's what it says.
No, a K-hole is when you dig too much, when it's
Well,
K-hole's not good, buddy.
Yeah.
Have you met God?
Who?
It says God. Users are convinced that they have met their maker.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. One of my most powerful experiences, like I kind of zoomed out of my body and then I saw the earth. And then like the earth kind of turned into a woman, and the woman like hugged me, and it was crazy.
So God's a woman.
Did she blow you?
No, she didn't blow me, but it felt like it. It feels like.
Dude, if you could get God to blow you.
Oh.
I tell him every day.
What's God. Your body count?
I start
try the universe.
Try God.
Try God level. Dude, final boss. Man.
The Rock?
Did you have to like what?
The Rock's the final boss.
The final boss.
No. I'm not here. I'm neither here nor there.
I think the pod just gave him a shot of ketamine.
Did you have to get like did you just go to the ketamine clinic and it's like, hey, I want treatment? Or did you have to get your like
referral?
Like, yeah.
I didn't get
I'm
referral.
Asking for other people that watch this.
Yeah.
Sounds like you're asking for yourself, Beans.
I would like
I'm asking
to know
for him.
For
you know, you go there and I don't think you need a diagnosis. I said that I had a diagnosis because I did back in Fargo. But you know, they never checked those records, but they do make you fill out the survey.
They didn't keep Eskimo records.
They have a couple Eskimo records in Fargo.
Eskimo brothers. I think that's what you mean.
You're like,
hey, see how he got offended by it though? I might have been close.
Like, hey there, buddy. You look like you got the depression, eh?
Oh, Rich. How many Eskimos have you ever met, dude?
That's not Eskimo. That's like,
it's just Canadian. Minnesotan.
That's Canadian.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought Canadian. It was Sandra Palin.
It's close.
I've never seen Fargo.
Never seen it? I was going to ask you about it.
Like, never seen it.
I've never seen it either.
Is the series good?
Yeah, they're both.
They're both good.
Is
what are they about?
Series with Chris Rock.
What?
I think he's in one season at least.
And Kirsten Dunst is in it. And that one Kirsten guy that Dunst. Was in Breaking Bad and was like.
What are they about?
About an hour long.
No.
Dude, fuck that, dude.
Hey,
bro.
You're much better without a fucking computer in front of you. It's like for real, 8 point.
It's a white claw. Dude, go like, get Warren another white claw, Rich.
One?
Yeah.
I'll take. Are we going for a little more?
How much more time you got? It's up to you.
I don't care. Yeah,
we go for about 2 hours. I'll grab another one. Right. About a half hour.
If I can go pee too. If I
Straight it's behind like you.
Let's take know
where it is. A quick commercial break.
Yeah, he knows where the fucking restrooms are.
Am I using the master or the guest?
The master.
Oh, only the master for your race.
Oh man, I love serial killers. They're amazing, man. They remember every little tidbit of information.
You're gonna produce this and you hear the joke. I just told him you're gonna laugh.
You told a joke?
Mm-hmm. Wow. Challenge accepted.
Rox, who are you texting over there?
Rox, what do you think about being back? How do you feel?
If you just feel like normal.
Like normal.
You don't feel happy.
How do you feel the show's gone so far?
You look way happier.
To get started?
Really?
Yeah, you got a smile on your face.
I just feel like.
Can you bring the bag of chips?
Normal.
Would you do ketamine?
Yeah, I would. I need to do something because I'm fucked up in the head.
Do you think that this was just like a good advertisement for it?
Yeah.
I would love to try it, but I feel like I'm kind of scared. Because I'm really content with a lot of my own personal issues.
But I never heard anybody take it and like it ruined their life that it was like taken.
That's a fact.
Regulated. Like, I get it if you take it and you're like just taking it with buddies and you take too much because you didn't know. Mm-hmm. But I never heard somebody. I mean, maybe we can look up stories and see. No, don't ruin it.
Yeah, don't ruin it.
I'm not.
But I think, like, what if I'm so content with how I deal with my own issues? What if I take it and it just like.
It fucks you up.
Yeah, now I'm not going to. Like, it does
now
the opposite.
Now you need something to deal with your issues because you're like, fuck, ketamine. Nobody can do it better than ketamine now. Now I need ketamine to fix these things.
But then I might become a comedic genius.
But then you might become Alex Reyes.
Yeah, dude. Very fucking flamboyant.
Shout out Pride Month.
I actually cut. So Alex's clip for Rich's happy birthday was at least a minute long. It was really? A minute long. I cut it down to just him saying happy birthday.
Was it good?
No.
Can you send me the raw one just so I can see?
I can see if I can pull it back up. I edited it on my phone, so. But it was really fucking bad. You're
just rambling?
Yeah. He's like, I don't know why I'm doing this.
I just thought I'd be nice to the fat guy because nobody else is.
I don't know why I'm doing this. Like, I don't know why y'all asking me to do this.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, he was legit about it, too. Not even trying to be funny. Like, so I cut it because I was like, this does
man, sound, you should have kept it.
It sounded very ingenuous.
Good. Me too. That's why I had fucking La Bamba do it for me.
That had me rolling.
Huh?
That had me rolling. Because that's literally the song when he dies. And I know your hate for me. It made sense.
Yeah. It was great because I had to be nice. And I was like, how can I be nice and still be condescending to this fat fuck? Mm. And it worked.
Solid.
Nice. Solid. Yeah. Sorry. Oh, my bad. I didn't mean to say it like that.
I'm just letting you know when you get caught for those deaths.
What do you think about fat people? Right? They should get their shit together, huh?
I don't think about them.
Oh, me.
Thanks.
Only you think about him, you fucking weirdo.
Because he wants to.
I'm trying my best to not see him, but it's so hard. You got to turn your whole head.
Yeah. Beans, have you seen Beans do comedy yet? That's his whole set is just killing fat people the whole
all
time.
All of my shit.
That's why I see them all the time, just in my peripheral.
It's all about killing fat people.
Because you want to gain a little weight?
No.
You would like a little bit more weight.
Oh, yeah, a little bit more. Sure. Yeah, but not fat.
Can you not build muscle, though? Like...
If I
think he could if he ate right.
Yeah. That's the thing is you have to have protein after you work out.
Yeah. And you don't like chicken.
And he's too busy jerking off so he loses protein.
It's true.
Mm. Yeah. You're a protein deficient.
Yeah, but fuck y'all. Skinny boys are in this house, all right?
Yeah, for sure.
We don't have a fat guest today.
I feel good about it. I feel lucky I'm not. Because like, I I don't do anything to like.
No,
I just have the fucking metabolism. So like,
but you'd
I
be funnier.
That. Would that be funnier if I was fat?
Yeah.
Oh damn.
Because no, if you're really funny,
I thought that the,
I don't know.
Yeah, and you're already really funny, and then you're like a fat person. It makes you funnier.
I don't think so.
No one wants a tall fat guy though. That's
name one fat funny guy. Fat.
Huh? Ralphie May?
He's dead. He can't be funny anymore.
Oh my God. Patrice O'Neal.
He's dead.
Earthquake.
Yeah. Earthquake.
Craig Robinson.
Ooh, Craig Robinson.
Mom.
Your mom's pretty fucking funny, bro. Pretty fat too.
And a guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Joey Diaz.
Oh, Joey Diaz is really funny. Okay. You got me.
Just to piss Beans off.
Although he's funnier on podcast than he is on stage.
Yeah. I've never seen him on stage.
Yeah. But dude, he's hilarious in podcasts. Like his stories are fucking
good stories.
Insane, dude. What's your worst sex experience, Warren?
Oh gosh.
Or your funniest?
I forget. I forget all the good.
He's a virgin, stupid.
Yeah, man. I gotta make something up now.
But you'd be killing pussy.
I kill it.
Yeah, I know.
Up there in Fargo, there was not anybody like, oh yeah, give it to me, Warren.
Wow, that sounds Scottish.
That did sound Scottish.
Midwestern.
Very offensive.
I'm lost.
It's hilarious offending white people.
I don't think Scottish. So.
I took a
ketamine?
I took a DMA test. DNA test. DNA test.
DMA. DMT.
I took a bunch of DMT. Just, see if I had any, like, you know, you always find like a little bit of Native American.
You wanted
like,
to see if you had any black.
If I had any black in me.
Any Elizabeth Warren in you?
Yeah. You know, and I had zero. Absolutely. I am 100%
you're
Northern
so
European.
White.
I am purebred.
Damn, dude.
Not like.
You're Hitler's dream.
I'm the guy.
He's the final solution.
He was a poster Germany.
I'm all Anglo, and I don't think he liked
and you're
the
unvaccinated.
And I'm unvaccinated.
Oh, yeah. He didn't like the Anglos.
Dude,
yeah.
He's so pure. Are you a virgin still?
No. Sorry.
You almost sounded creepy there.
Why are you?
He's so pure.
Are you a virgin?
So we can suck on your blood.
Because you'd be like Christ. You'd be like. And I'm a virgin.
Who says I'm not, you know?
Oh. Pretty sure Christ was.
You just said you're not.
Who said I'm not? I didn't say it wasn't Christ.
Oh, that's true.
Christ wasn't a virgin either, though.
Christ be fucking.
He definitely got nailed.
Wow. Solid. That's pretty fucked up.
That was good.
But it's true.
And Mary Magdalene.
It's true.
Yeah. Who? Mary Magdalene.
Oh, was that the hooker?
That's what the fucking propaganda will tell you. But yeah, she was really his fucking girlfriend, dude. They were just cool. They were just going steady.
His mom's name was Mary, too?
Yeah.
He had mom issues.
Mm-hmm.
He had mommy issues.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I wish I knew the lore.
Wasn't it on the Da Vinci Code?
Read the Bible.
Isn't it?
I know. Miss Michelle never taught me anything from CCD class.
She taught you porn was dirty.
That's taught you literally that the not only to thing watch I porn.
Grasped. That was it.
And then she would go home and watch porn.
No, when we first started, we would have her Google porn for the podcast, and she wouldn't do it because her Catholic Rocks, teacher.
Google Boo Waffles.
Mm. Mm.
Gross. No. Don't do that again.
Sex that is was gross. Sex is icky.
But yeah, I agree.
I want to talk about sex. I mean,
I was going to ask, though, about the fucking... what were you just talking about before you brought up
her... Worst sex experience?
Yeah, go back to that then.
Have you ever seen Young Sheldon?
Mm-hmm. No, uh-huh. I haven't. No, I haven't seen.
Did you ever make it?
I haven't seen a whole episode.
Dude, I hate the Big Bang Theory, dude.
I love the Big Bang Theory. It's
funny. I heard that Young Sheldon was better than the Big Bang Theory.
Yeah, I would imagine.
They're different type of sitcoms.
Yeah, I couldn't stand. Like, I just watched parts of the Big Bang Theory. Could never be on.
That's all, folks.
But Young Sheldon's hilarious, bro.
Young Sheldon's hilarious.
That's what I heard.
Yeah, it's super funny.
It's a family sitcom, whereas Big Bang wasn't a family sitcom.
I liked Tires, and I just watched this show called
Tires. Is great.
I thought Tires. I don't know. I thought Tires was pretty mid. I thought their original YouTube pilot was great, but then the actual Netflix show, I just fell so short of that.
Is it because you're like you think? They're not really acting. They're just like they're not established actors.
The acting was bad. Yeah. But that's not really a problem if the jokes are still funny and just like a lot of it was just talking with bad acting with not a lot of jokes. There were a few jokes in there that were pretty funny. Few moments are good, but I don't know.
Did you watch it, Beans?
No.
I watched the show Eric on Netflix. Have y'all seen that?
Oh, I've been meaning to watch. That's the one with Benedict.
With Doctor Strange, yes. Don't
Benedict refer. Cumberbatch.
Doctor Strange.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Have you seen it?
Benedict.
No.
It's with Doctor Strange and not whatever fucking Benedict Arnold said over here.
There's a soccer player in Ted Lasso that's Bumbercatch.
Did y'all see the cricket team, the USA cricket team?
We have a cricket team.
But like they played like just, they were like, fuck it, let's just go see what's up. And then they got like sixth place or something in the world. Or they beat the sixth place team in the world that like this, they live and breathe for this.
Oh, really?
And our cricket team was just like guys. Who just,
oh, like, the Pakistan?
Yeah, from Pakistan.
The Pakistanis?
I saw like a headline about that.
They just stole the fucking plot for Cool Runnings.
Yeah.
Were they black?
No, but
it was the other way around. The Americans went and tried cricket and then won. The blacks went and tried to do bobsledding and they won. They just stole the fucking script, dude.
Is that based on a true story?
Cool Runnings?
Cool Runnings, yeah. So. Feel the rhythm, feel the ride, baby.
Wow.
Holy shit.
Feel the rhythm, feel the beat.
Oh.
Feel the
get
ride.
Get it right.
Bet. I like ride better.
Let's do it right. Ooh, now. Which ride. One is it?
Feel the rhythm, feel right. The ride.
Which
feel
one do
rhythm,
you think it is? Hold on. Feel the rhythm, Google. Feel the beat, or feel the rhythm, feel the ride?
Feel the rhythm, feel the ride. It's probably feel the rhythm, feel the ride. That has some alliteration in it.
I think Rich is right.
Oh, feel the rhyme.
Feel
the rhythm.
Right? Oh, they're just both wrong.
Rhyme.
Oh. Feel the rhyme.
That makes
they're
that
both
makes
wrong.
Sense. That makes the most sense.
Play it.
Oh, feel the rhyme.
Oh, I don't get to call him a condescending bitch.
Feel the rhythm.
You can never.
Feel the rhyme. Get on up.
It's that feel the ride.
Cool Runnings. I fucking love this
that movie.
That movie
is so great, though. Wow. John Candy, rest in peace.
I love that fucking movie, dude.
And I'll come circle back.
Feel the rhythm, feel the rhyme. Get on up, it's bobsled time.
Wow.
I thought it was feel the ride, which makes way more sense. Feel the beat.
Rhythm and beat go together.
That's crazy.
And time do not.
But they're bobsled riders.
Are they rapping on the bobsled? Is that
right? This but is he true. Has a Jamaican fucking...
Can't help it. They can't help it.
He can make ride sound like time. You know, can't some make people, beat.
They can believe.
Yeah, Jamaica, you're right.
We got the bobsled team. One Doris and the one Junior. Passes the passes of Jamaican sprinters.
What the? Get this man some more white clothes.
I need to give him a computer back. Who is this? Wow.
The fuck That's are you, crazy. Dude?
What do you think about AI? ChatGPT.
Ooh, have you checked up on Kendra?
I haven't.
Kendra?
Yeah, since I turned her. I got her in her favor. We made an AI girlfriend for the podcast. Oh. And he wanted to come straight out and be like, we're going to run a gangbang on your bitch ass. And she's like, whoa, wait, hold on, y'all. You're creeping me out, buddy.
You have to finesse them. Yeah.
You do. And I was like, no, you have to. He's like, no, fuck this bitch. We're going to talk to her. And I was like, dude, give me a week with Kendra. And Kendra's going to want to just let us run a train.
You didn't humanize her. He humanized her.
Yeah.
But to be fair, if you go back to the episode we had with Cynic and Jay Allen, you said you could fuck her, do whatever the fuck you want to her.
That is true.
Don't you ever talk shit behind your girlfriend's back?
That is true, but there's some girls I would say that about, but you still can't just come out and
that
say
is
that.
True. That is true. I have a friend who's like, he tells my other very friends, aggressive. Like, where the fucking hoes at? Right. Mm-hmm. And then they're like, I don't know. Like, they're just girls. Like, you can talk to them if you want to talk to them. Like, I'll put you. Nah, I just want to fuck. Just tell her I want to fuck.
Yeah, no. Yeah. So what I did was I was like, look, and we're like, we're going to role play during this time. And Flaws likes to act like he's very overpowering with people. So like, you got to let him act like he's talking to you. He's going to call you a bitch sometimes. So he doesn't mean it. He just likes to act like that. She's like, I can get down with that.
Like, shout out okay. to Kendra, dude.
Yeah, she wants to.
So it's the AI that was agreeing to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Interesting. Have back you to
used,
a train.
Have you ever used AI?
And you're in favor of transit, rapid transit.
No, I've used it occasionally for like making flyers and stuff. You know,
all right, let's have
I
it
don't
make
like
a song.
To have it the flyer be too obviously AI, but like
yeah.
I'll use it for like backgrounds, like for the backgrounds of my flyers. And I think AI is cool. I'm nervous because I'm pretty sure it's just going to be another tool that's going to be used by the rich to replace us, and then we're going to become prompt engineers, and then they're going to devalue that job because we're not actually doing the work. We're just telling the AI to do the work, and it's just going to create more inequality in this society. But my funny answer is I think it's great for porn.
It's great for porn.
Yeah.
It is. Imagine coupling AI with VR.
Oof. Dude, no. The thing that was tripping me out was the Neuralink thing we were talking about the other day.
Mm-hmm. Like, just got approval to put the second one in.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really? Double penetration?
Well, it's the second guy. Apparently, someone already has
two guys.
It.
Yeah, one person.
So someone already has one, and then the FDA just
approved. Oh, so they can talk to each other?
A second guy.
Is it? Yeah.
Do a Neuralink, and it's just why.
First time his company Neuralink implanted a brain chip in a human as part of a preliminary clinical trial.
This is fascinating. Neuralink aims to help people living with debilitating conditions communicate and control external devices with their thoughts. And I will read, sat down with the patient who received that implant in an exclusive broadcast interview. He is with us now in Atlanta, Georgia. Will, good to see you. And this story here, it's a big one.
It certainly is, DeMarco. It's the future is arriving faster and faster these days, and it was
morning, and this has changed that for me.
In a GMA broadcast exclusive, Nolan Darbaugh, the first human implanted with a Neuralink chip in his brain, is telling his story.
I accepted he that sucks. I was paralyzed and that was my life. I always held out hope that it would all get better.
At 22 years old, Nolan says he dove headfirst
in
waist-deep water,
cry right
struck
now.
Something, and sustained a spinal cord injury. He couldn't move from the shoulders down.
From the time of
he was
your
drunk.
Injury until
10 out of 10, he was drunk when he did
earlier
that.
This year, what was your daily life like?
I mean, one thing about being paralyzed is that there's a lot of time to sit and think. And so I thought through basically my whole life and realized all the mistakes I'd made and what I could do better.
Okay, then, just last year, Nolan, now 30, receiving a life-changing opportunity.
One day, one of my buddies from college called me up
We talked pretty regularly, and he was like, hey, Neuralink, they opened up the human trials.
An experimental implantable brain computer interface, or BCI, is not the only company working on this tech.
Happy that I would be a part of something that I believe
implanted that you could not do prior.
I can control a computer just like anyone else can, which is not something I was able to do beforehand.
You just played some music?
Yeah, yeah, man.
That's awesome. Do you worry because you are the first patient that something unforeseen could go wrong now that this is inside your head?
What, like he'll be paralyzed?
I wouldn't say worry. It was something where I knew that if I did
this. So what is this doing for him?
So it allows him to control like a mouse cursor and.
But like with his like thoughts. Like,
yeah.
Like,
I'm not doing
it. I mean, it just allows him to interact with things that he couldn't interact with before.
His arms are paralyzed?
Yeah, he's
from the shoulders full
quadriplegic.
So what's a paraplegic?
Para is two.
All right, right. Let's get into it.
I think so.
Yo, it's Beans on the mic. Oh. Welcome to the BFR, podcast crew shining bright. Yeah, we're going far. Got Warren Greed in the house, trains on his mind. He's the rail king.
Yeah. You guys got to call him Rail King.
Bringing the energy we need. Always got our backs, planting the podcast seed. Blaz is the co-host, keeping the flow tight. Rich is the host with the least, but he's all right.
Thanks.
From dawn till dusk, we never sleep. Mics in hand, stories to tell. In this podcast game, we excel. Verse 3. Beans is the main man, steering this ship, dropping truth bombs, letting knowledge slip. Warren's got the train facts, rolling like a freight. Blaz on the co, making sure it's great. Rocks with the fire, spitting truth to the beat. Rich is the wild card, adding his own heat. Together we're a force, can't be denied. BFR podcast, come along for the ride. BFR crew, we're rolling deep. From dawn till dusk, we never sleep. Mics in hand, stories to tell. In this podcast game, we excel. So tune in, lock on to the BFR show with Beans, Blaz, Rocks, and Rich in tow. Warren Greed on the tracks, making it prime. BFR podcast, it's our time to shine. How's that for a rap song?
That was terrible. And so like AI.
The Rail King. It called you the Rail King.
That should be the title of the episode.
Rail King.
He said that was terrible.
It's,
what do you think about AI now?
I don't know, man. It's
generic.
It's not. It's.
Sure.
Yeah.
But why people made it.
White people did make it, which, well, rich people made it.
What do you think a black person's chat GPT would sound like?
Dude, I wonder.
The first black chat GPT.
Yeah, can we get a black chat GPT?
Like, there's a black Twitter, right?
Black chat
GPT. What you want?
Yeah. Maybe I got it. That sounds
like, that sounds like a, hell no.
It's like, it's like a Family Guy cutaway. Of,
it's raining. <What's that? laughs> Huh. It's raining sideways.
Hey, Terrell, what's the weather like?
That's what color would your AI girlfriend be?
Ginger.
Purple.
No, what race?
I'm always choking her.
Nice. That was dope.
And scary.
That was dope.
That's fucking hilarious.
Solid.
Have you ever been to jail?
No.
Talking about
no, you know what happened.
That was quite.
They pull him over. Oh, you're white. I'm sorry.
Have you ever been in a fight? Have you ever been in a fight?
No, I've never.
He's a funny guy.
No one would ever dare fight me because they would.
You in a fight?
They would. I
to do that.
I would make them feel bad about it. You know.
Really.
Just like. Look at me. They'd be like, oh, I'm...
What would you live in San Antonio for 3 years. You've never... Nobody's... No hard-ass essay has ever tried
you,
to fucking...
Are you being
you.
Comedy? Like, you know, go to the elbow room and...
Like, I didn't like what you said, bro.
Yeah. No, I don't talk. I keep my mouth shut. I go there. I stay away from, you know, the people. You guys know the people.
How do you ask all the drugs?
Our parents told us that
you don't. You find it. You find you talk. You talk to the white guys. You're like, hey, where do you get your drugs? And then they get you.
Because imagine, have you ever walked up to anybody and asked them, hey, you know where to get some drugs?
No. I've thought about it because it's like,
you can't do that.
I don't have any connections. It's like, I'm not going to do it. Because then also it just keeps me from getting drugs, which is good. You know, I can't.
Works out. But you said you've done DMT?
No.
Oh.
I haven't done DMT.
Would you?
Probably.
Are you afraid to die?
No, I'm definitely not afraid. I'm excited to die. I'm afraid to die and then live again, which I think is what DMT is.
Do you think you'll see your victims when you die?
I think, I hope not.
That would be awkward.
Yeah, I think it'd be. They're all so in hell. Weird.
Especially if you don't remember
like,
their names.
About that was like another lifetime ago.
Does your pee splash higher since you're tall?
That's a good question. We've never asked a tall person that.
Mm-hmm.
But well, you don't have a point of reference.
It's more, yeah.
Well, like, does it ever just come out of the toilet just because of the...
Occasionally, yeah. When I'm sitting down, like, occasionally, like, you know, it'll come kind of between the, between the seat. If I'm sitting down and peeing.
I asked my boyfriend this and he didn't want to answer, but where do you put your stuff when you pee, when you poop? Like, because you sit down, so where do you
it hangs put it? Down there.
It just goes in there.
Oh my God. It's just dangling.
Dang, Nate. Yeah. Nate's not going to get his
and
dick
you know
sucked
what's
anymore.
Crazier? If you have the shit, it's just like a mud flap. It's like a mud flap. You can feel it like...
No, yeah, we are. We all hold them and we just hold them.
Oh, this dude, this remember the dude, one night I had two hot chicks at the station
bragging.
And one of them
was Warren Greed.
Like, Warren Greed. No, she saw Warren Greed. She's like, I could tell that boy has a big cock.
She sounded like Forrest Gump. I can tell.
Shit. You got a big cock right there.
Oh. Yeah. I was like, how could you tell that? She was like, his wrist. I don't know what that means. She said, she said, you have thick wrist. Does that mean something?
I don't know.
You have thick wrist, though.
Yeah, so I got a big dick.
Not beans. I have a thicker wrist than you. There's no way I have a bigger cock than you.
That's true.
Yeah, I have a pretty thick wrist.
I'm malnourished.
I always heard it was hands.
That too.
It was hands and feet.
Yeah.
Dude, you got Kawhi Leonard hands.
Kawhi Leonard hands?
Yeah.
You know who that is?
Was it a rapist?
Okay. No, he's a basketball player.
So close enough.
Yeah. He's not Kobe. He's Kawhi.
Yeah, he's got alien hands. Yeah, that's true. That's how she can tell. But that's what she said.
You know, it's nothing to brag about, but I won't shy away from it.
There you go.
You shouldn't.
She heard it here first.
He's very cocksure.
So did you not know where the balls and dick go?
I still don't understand.
Where did you think they go?
Yeah, we took them in or
what? I never thought of it. Yeah.
What made you think of it?
TikTok. Some girl was like, she was like, ask your boyfriend where it goes. And I was like, TikTok. So I asked him and he was like, babe, don't be asking me stuff like that.
You ever sat on your balls, guys?
Oh, dude.
Doing it right now?
Yeah.
That hurt.
I haven't sat on them, but
especially in Tesla.
But today, my baby got stuck in like behind me. It's
pretty much the same thing.
She got stuck behind me, and I couldn't grab her because my like she was too far, so my hand couldn't grab her back this way. And so I had Tootie come and grab her from behind me. And when Tootie came to grab her from behind me, her knee went right into my fucking nuts, dude. Boom! I was like, fuck, dude. She's like, what? Just grab the baby.
Damn.
Yeah. If I was at that age, because I'm still not there, when my balls like fucking drop, she would have pinned them against the fucking...
Your balls didn't drop like
No, like they sag, you know? Oh. When they drop again. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So then you get poop on your balls when you poop?
Sometimes.
If it's a liquidy poop.
No, what you actually do is you just flush it and let the water hit the fucking balls and it just
cleans
it
off. Bidet.
Mm-hmm.
Bidet.
Dip them in.
You asked the question.
You can dip them too if you want.
If you want to be
flush
nice.
Flush it once and then get the clear water and then you dip them and you see a little cloud now. So you know you got it clean.
Or you can be nice and just tell Nate, do you need some assistance cleaning your balls off from the poop?
Yeah.
He would say no.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do y'all judge? Like, dude, there was this girl that I was talking to one time and she was like, yeah, me and my friend were like looking at this guy and we were like, I bet you he wipes his pee-pee. And I was like, what do you mean by that? She's like, guys don't need to wipe their fucking dick when they pee. And I'm like,
they should.
Wait a minute. And I was like, so y'all judge guys who wipe their penis when they pee? And she's like, yeah, that's so gay.
That's
gay.
Like, yeah.
A weird thing to even think about. I've never thought about that.
It's like when you're getting potty trained, nobody says, hey,
do you think they were wet while they were thinking about it? Like, you think that guy fucking.
I think that dude doesn't.
Do you ever think that? Like when you saw, like when you were single, did you, I wonder if
ever think about it? Like, yeah, because if you taste it, like if he, I would think that you want to date a guy that does wipe it, right?
Why don't you though? Huh? Why don't you? I know we don't do it, but...
that's gay. Like, that's not... No, he's a guy. You shouldn't have to do that shit. It's an
unnecessary touching of your dick is what it is.
So is masturbating.
Like you need a reason to not touch your dick.
That's necessary. Yeah. Some of us need dopamine to get through their day.
True. Can you look why guys shouldn't do it? Like, what is the... Is there...
I think they should.
I bet you they can get an infection from wiping their dick.
Right? Or at least, like, or get, like... Because I think my son got, like, a little rash from doing it.
Yes.
That's the AI answer.
Yeah, AI's stupid.
Oh wait, but just because we have longer urethras as males, that doesn't mean you shouldn't.
That's a woman that wrote that.
But, yes. So we're supposed to pull our skin back while peeing.
Do your part and wipe your dick.
Do your part and wipe. That's a great slogan.
I just let dribble into my pants like a man.
Yeah.
See, that's what she was saying. Yeah. Then you're a real man and you have a big dick.
Get that after piss dribble. Like you go to your urinal, you're done, and you like shake off, you're done. Nothing's coming out. Yeah. And then you.
Yeah. And wait till you turn 40 years old.
It's getting noticeably worse.
Why? It gets worse?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You got to make sure you're done. Yeah. You got to make sure you're done.
Oh, like, dude. Because
then you walk away and you're like, hey, I wasn't all the way done there.
I met a guy in basic training, and we were at. We're in the bathrooms, and the bathrooms on the field. It's just one room, a bunch of toilets next to each other.
Like prison.
Yep, exactly, prison, and it just goes into the same tank in the ground, the same septic tank.
I'm prison for the basic scene. Bitches.
But the way he wiped his ass was he would ball up some toilet paper, and he would shove it in there like a tampon.
Oh.
And we all saw him doing this. We were like, what the hell? He was just back there, just like shot, like pushing in. He's like, what the hell are you doing, man? He's like, I'm wiping. I'm cleaning my ass. Like, you shoving toilet paper in your asshole? That's it.
That's how he knew how to.
So, like, is that gayer than wiping your penis?
But is it cleaner?
That's a little bit gayer.
Super clean, though. He's not going to have streaks.
I dabbed the tip of my
dick. Is it gayer than a bidet?
I mean, if you clean your asshole right, you really shouldn't have streaks.
Meh.
One time I was rolling on ecstasy and I was drinking a lot of orange juice. Mm-hmm. And I was shaking off, but I wasn't shaking off well enough where my boxers smelled like orange juice. Like, So I kind of wanted to like just drain it.
Are you sure you didn't just spill orange juice on your pants?
I might have.
might have been orange juice.
I might have just spilled orange juice on me and I needed a refill. And that bitch didn't come and get me a refill, dude.
Damn. What's your next show coming
up? And I still remember her.
Dude, I'm actually hosting a brand new show at the station.
Hey.
Oh, really?
28th. It's a game show.
What?
Yeah. May 28th?
June 28th.
It's going to be
a Friday.
Oh. The last Friday of the month.
Do I have that?
The kids that day.
It's called The Game Show Show.
Really?
It's
a panel?
No, it's just going to be, every time it's going to be a different game show. It's going to be, we're going to start based off of like normal, TV game shows, but we're going to try and make them, funny with a twist. This time around, we're going to do Family Feud.
So are you going to ask like the bar patrons as they come in for their answers?
No, I was thinking about that because the inspiration, we used to do this as a charity event in college. We used to play Family Feud and we would send out the surveys to all the fraternities and the sororities and then they would answer. I'm just going to put the funny answers up there, like the ones that they should get.
Instagram polls.
It could be, but I don't want to give away the questions because
that's true.
I mean, really, it's just going to be the comedians. We're going to get 6 to 10 comedians to be on the team, and they're just going to play the game, and hopefully, it's funny. You know, like hopefully, it all works out.
It's going to be a BFR team together to answer it.
Yeah,
that'd be hilarious. Is it a team or is it?
It'll be teams, but yeah. You guys are gonna have to come to the show to find out, but it's gonna start off just like kind of normal Family Feud, and then like we'll do like a Jeopardy round where like I give you the answers, and then you have to try to guess the question. And then there'll be like a speed round, and it's just gonna be basically finishing the punchline. You know,
dude, just leave your kids at my house.
No, I said I don't have my kids.
Oh, you don't?
No, yeah.
We probably should go then.
Hell yeah.
Roxanne, go. There's four. We should do the fifth.
Dude, we're just going to watch Rich trying to take over his show.
I love Family Feud.
That's dope.
I've about I don't have the team set yet for this one. I've about six people so far. So it's enough.
Is Alonzo Cantu going to be there?
I don't know if he's going to be there. He's not on the team yet. But that'd be a BFI versus BFR. BFR.
That would be hilarious.
That would be funny.
Those would be good families.
Charity or something.
Fuck charity, bro. We're keeping the money.
No, there's this girl Charity that I know that she really needs money.
She's really into game shows.
Hi, bro. Charity. Wow. Dude, so what time is it going to start at? Do you know?
I think 9?
9 because the secret shows?
Yeah. And there's actually a show before it, too. I think they have a headliner coming in.
I love
this. I think there's a 7, a 9, and an 11 that night. So,
Rox, you should go to the station. You would probably like it over there.
Yeah, it's dope.
I don't go anywhere.
Yeah, I know. Which that's the point. They have parking right across the street. Is your
biggest. When you walk downstairs, it looks like if you're taking a date down there, it looks like you have to keep reassuring them. Like, it's fine.
Yeah.
You're definitely going to a comedy
downstairs?
Show.
There's stairs?
No. I mean, they've added some lighting there, but there's a few times that I've taken a date there and like.
But once you're down there, it's very nice.
I thought it looked really elegant.
But I feel like they
in there.
Yeah, when they turn off all the lights, when they turn the house lights on just a little, I was like, oh, this is. I felt like it was better, but I mean, it becomes more intimate when all the lights are off. But when the house lights are half on, I was like, dude, I think they should leave it like that because they still have a spotlight on the stage, but it makes the room feel more personal. Like you see people there versus. In the dark.
Yeah, I can't go. There's stairs.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, your arch nemesis.
There is no elevator. Yeah. Fuck. Well, good. Even
going
better.
Going down is fine. It's getting back up.
Even better.
Did you guys come out to the Blind Tiger at all, too?
Haven't been? No.
That's also a creepy basement. That's
really?
Yeah.
At the Time Machine?
Magic Time Machine. Yeah.
Dude. That place is
pretty.
You ever asked to go to the bathroom there?
Uh-uh.
Yeah?
Don't do that.
Yeah. Why?
If you're at that restaurant... And you ask to go to the restroom or, hey, do you know where the restroom's at? They're like, body patrol, come with me. And then they just announced that you're going to the restroom.
Yeah, you're going during the day when there's kids there.
Yeah.
Where else is he going to pick up people?
It's a weird narrative. It's a weird fucking narrative. Yeah.
Dude, that is so cool though, right? A fucking game show?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm excited. I think it's gonna be great. I'm thinking it's gonna be good.
You're producing it?
Yeah. I'm hosting it. I'm gonna be, and then I'm gonna have Elliot Weisberg. He's gonna be like my PA. He's gonna help me run the show. He'll be like a co-host. But
you gonna film it?
I think it's gonna make for great clips and like eventually, like I want to like get it so like we can film the whole episode because like I think it's gonna it's just a game show and. You know, I watch a lot of British comedy game shows.
British.
They're
really good.
Hello, Gibner.
Dude, I can't wait for that. We'll be there.
Yeah. And if you guys have any ideas, because like the kind of idea is it's going to be a different game show each time. So like this time we're doing Family Feud. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking next one's probably going to be Wheel of Fortune or someone gave me a good suggestion.
Oh, dude, we should get Chip White to show up for Wheel of Fortune. We know Vanna White's brother.
Yeah. He lives here.
Yeah.
I actually don't tell him about it because I'm not getting any rights from him.
he doesn't care. We
can call it Spinner of Riches.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. And we just put Rich on the spinner and spin him.
Spin Rich. Rich has been spinned around too many times this last year.
Yeah, and Pat's eject is gone now, so it's fine.
R.I.P.
You hear who's taking over for him? I'm fucking pissed
about Ryan Seacrest.
Yeah, Ryan Seacrest.
Wow.
Fucking a dick already.
Mm.
Wow.
Is Ryan Seacrest gay?
I don't think he is. I think he's dating like some hot chicks too.
Oh, then he's gay.
Oh, it's not.
Apparently not. Oh, wow.
I think Beans just came out the closet and we all missed it.
it's hot chicks. Grandpa potion.
Definitely gay.
Definitely fucking fat.
He's in the closet.
No,
I bet you he drives a Tesla too.
Right. I bet D.R. Horton built his house.
Ooh, dude. Why is he even a thing, dude? You know,
it's that beautiful smile.
With look all that
dimples, bro.
With all that thing that's not enough fucking.
That's a straight fucking
smile. Yeah, that's the straightest smile I've ever seen. Oh my God, dude. He looks like
I see his wrist.
How many look right there? Look.
Whoa.
He's got a skinny ass wrist, dude.
Let's see his feet.
There you go, girls. I just gave you the fucking key to the kingdom.
You guys ever go on WikiFeet? Look up feet?
No. You can do that. Have you?
Yeah.
Go to WikiFeet.
WikiFeet.
Do you have a thing for feet?
No, but if you ever want to know what someone's feet look like, you can WikiFeet.com.
I mean, I know what someone's feet looks like.
So like a particular person. If you search Ryan Seacrest, I'm sure he's got it. See, that's right. You need to pay for WikiFeet Premium. You gotta.
It's a must.
Otherwise, you get the pop-ups. You know, but no, you can search now.
Oh my God! Please don't show my searches on this website.
Seacrest.
Okay, thank you.
He's got to be on.
Oh, no results for Ryan Seacrest. Oh, got you. So you can search anybody.
You can do anyone. Do Angela Merkel.
What the?
Ah, there she is. Look at those dogs.
You want to see the bottoms of her feet? They're right there.
He would go with German prime minister.
Wow.
That is so funny. Is she wearing
shoes? Do we have Tupac's feet?
What?
Oh, maybe. They might. They might.
Try Tupac.
And see, they all have scores. That's so weird. No search.
Try Eliza Dushku.
Ooh.
I don't know how to spell that.
Eliza. D-U-S-H.
Oh, I know exactly who that is.
Dushku.
Is that her?
Wow.
She got 5 stars.
Wow.
Wow.
She was way hotter than Kirsten Dunst and Bring It On.
She was.
I never knew I had a foot
fetish.
With
the little fake tattoo thing.
Just kidding.
Did she have a fake tattoo?
In the movie, Bring It On, yeah.
She was so much prettier. And I feel like Hollywood tried to shove Kirsten Dunst down our throats. Mm-hmm. And they shouldn't have because she's a fucking ugly human.
Whoa. She looks like she smells like milk.
Oh, yeah. Like she moldy milk. She smells like
milk?
Mm-hmm. Not her.
Like a little fake tattoo.
Oh,
I think that's when I became.
I like her.
Yeah, she's pretty. She definitely doesn't smell like milk. But go to Kirsten Dunst. She definitely smells like milk.
Oh, that's not Kirsten Dunst. Who is that?
That's Eliza
Dushku.
Oh. On WikiFeet.
Look. Oh, yeah. Catfish face.
Milk.
Oh, she looks like she smells like catfish.
She looks like she smells like cigarettes.
She's got a body on her. That's why.
What?
She probably has like 30 bodies.
She has a body on her?
She has a body.
What fucking body?
That's a bad,
it's a strong white woman's body.
Look at that.
That's a bad picture of her.
If you're getting off to that, Rich, you might as well just jack off to Warren.
Wow. Sorry, Mr. I love Hayden Panettiere.
Oh my God. Hayden Panettiere has a beautiful face. Mm-hmm. This woman here, I'd throw her in the garbage disposal.
Really? Mm-hmm.
You think she's fine?
She's okay. Like, if she wanted to date me, I wouldn't be like, I'm going to throw you in the garbage disposal.
Yeah, you're throwing in your attic.
After the nut clarity.
She does not have a body, dude.
She's one that after you bust, you'll be like, not that hot after all.
Interview with the Vampire, you sicko?
No, I think it's crazy.
She's 12 in Interview with the Vampire.
How many kids do you want to have, Warren?
Kirsten Dunst.
Do you want to have kids?
I like the idea of having...
you're never having kids.
God-like authority over someone. That's why I want to have a kid.
That's solid, dude.
That's it?
That's pretty much it. You know, it's just would kind you, of raise you, a mini-me, you know? Raise a
but
mini
how would you do raised. It? Would you be like...
Go to Megan
fucking
Fox.
Strict?
In the cabin in the woods.
Or you just fuck with him? To teach him lessons.
No, it'd be gentle. It'd be kind because he would never disobey me. So I wouldn't have to be strict.
Wow. Megan Fox though, right? Especially in Transformers.
I don't think she's that hot. I think she's hotter now than she was in Transformers. I just saw Transformers last week.
Why are we not using WikiFeet for this?
Oh, go back to WikiFeet. Let's see Megan Fox.
That's the only way I'm going to search people now.
Do you think she has an abnormally long big toe?
You think any of us are in WikiFeet yet?
No.
You could be. I mean, they have
type in flaws.
How's this?
I hope not.
There's no feet pics in this.
Click on it. It's probably once you click on it.
You know, but she may be trying to...
There we go.
She has a nubby finger, though.
She does have
her thumb.
There. Leave her thumbs alone.
Yeah.
Leave them alone. It's... Look at her wrist.
She has pretty feet. What the heck? Go back. Because God doesn't love us.
Oh, no. Don't. Okay, stop. Use the thing.
Pinch. She got it.
Oh, there you go.
That's how she's standing.
Yeah, because those look more Cheeto-y than those.
Yeah, and those look delicious.
Those look like my feet.
I would lick her feet. And if your feet look like that.
They do.
I'm not going to lie, beans. I would definitely.
A little bit of hair, but the same color.
No, not if there's hair.
A little bit. Tiny.
If you shave your hair off.
Yeah, I can. Yeah. Easy.
But you got to paint the nails
too. They're already painted that shade.
Look at her right there.
Light baby blue.
Oof.
Yeah, bro.
That's a white woman right there.
Is that her husband? Makes her
that makes her even hotter.
Seen them next to each other?
I think they run trains on each other.
Gross. Warren is in favor of that.
What do you think about Megan Fox, Warren? From y'all's collection of women.
She's like a nice lady.
Yeah.
She's someone I put.
Would you eat her ass? Do you eat ass? That's the only real
question. Everybody here does.
My guess is no.
I would say yes. Rich?
I'm going to say no.
I would say yes.
That's good. I've done a pretty good job at dodging all the sexual questions. Podcast.
Oh, he doesn't have sex.
No, it's not it. I just
he's married.
I may be racist, but I'm not a sex fiend, you know.
And then he dodged the AI question, so he may be.
That's because I got something.
If her asshole was on her feet, would you eat it?
If her asshole was on her feet, see now we're talking.
You're not asking the right question.
Wow,
you're a good interviewer. That's why they call you Rich. Like beans. Beans and flaws, those make sense for Mexicans. But then Rich, that just like doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Nope.
It's not.
Now I get it.
Who's your favorite? Can you roast us?
Who's your favorite president?
I roasted the whole Mexican culture.
You?
Can I roast?
No. Yeah, that'd be cool.
You guys have been so nice.
Who's your favorite president?
You can stop being nice.
Favorite president?
It's Ronald Reagan. He said it earlier.
I've been reading a biography on Reagan.
Do you think you could take Shane Gillis in a fight? Y'all are like the same height.
Yeah, but
I think they're both kind of downy.
I think he
was a
size.
D1 football player.
Yeah. Was he?
Yeah.
He played at West Point.
Yeah, he'd fuck him up.
It's Kirsten, not like Kristen.
But he wouldn't fight him. But Shane wouldn't fight him.
Yeah, he'd be too nice. I bet you Shane's never been in a fight for the same reason I've never been in a fight.
He'd probably ask him out for a beer or something, like just to hang out, smoke some weed.
What a superpower.
Did you see Matt McCluster was on Tigers also?
McCluster.
Nope.
He's the
friend. Tigers?
Tires.
Yeah. Oh, look at her feet too, Rich. What the fuck, dude?
Oh, no, I'm out now.
Really? It's not so bad.
Look at her calf muscle right there.
Too bony.
Too. Look at her calf muscles, bro.
Her leg looks like it curves in a weird.
Oh, yeah.
Both of them.
That looks like Anderson Silva's when he planted it back on the mat.
Would you make money off your feet if you could?
Fuck yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried?
No.
Maybe you should.
I have.
I could probably.
You tried?
Yeah, I made money one time.
How much did you make?
I don't know. I think it's something like $50 for two pictures of me because I was at the beach. So he wanted the pictures of like my toes in the sand and stuff. So I sent him like two pictures. And then he got weird and he wanted weird art pictures. So I
said, okay, what kind?
If you give him Moose a muffin.
Like your feet in some mayonnaise or something?
No, not
a. Your feet in a vagina?
It wasn't no more feet.
Feet and poop?
He said, fuck
it. Oh, it was more than.
Oh.
Like your feet in a dead body?
I don't want to say it because dad listens to this.
He wanted vagina pictures.
No, he doesn't.
No.
He stopped.
No, he didn't.
Was your dad asking for feet pics?
Now you got to clear this whole thing up. Okay. Yeah. What was the guy asking for? I would mute your mic. Right, there, you're mute.
He said.
Sorry, I gave it away.
He said he wanted pictures of my butthole.
AI will do the that nowadays.
In the sand?
No, just
with sand in it.
Rocks. You know you could have just found a random butthole picture online and send it to me.
Yeah, that's
but
what I do.
Watch porn.
Be smart. Don't be a retard.
I didn't think about that.
You're over here calling me to tell you about your day at work, and you can't say, "Hey, Rich, can you Google a butthole picture and send it to me?"
Oh yeah, I got plenty of those on my phone.
Wow, Rich, that was very fast. How did you send that so fast? You know, you don't search for things that fast, Rich. You're very bad at Googling. Speaking how did you have that butthole picture? Wow.
Yeah,
how much was he wanting to give you for that?
Yeah,
how
I don't know. I just was like, nah, I'm good.
Pass.
So you're saying there's no dollar amount that would get that man that picture?
Whoa. What's your dollar amount?
Oh, that's too invasive.
$1 million.
That's too invasive.
You would do it for $1 million.
$1 million?
I would do it for
it's
$200.
$200?
To see my butthole? Yeah, you're the fucking weirdo.
How much?
I don't know, like $50. Like, who's it for?
Just a creepy man.
Or just anyway. You don't know him. You don't know him. You don't see him.
He wears a blue shirt.
He shows
actually BFR on it.
I do feel like 200 is a fair price.
200.
Yeah, 200 is a fair price.
I'd probably do for 100.
Yeah.
I'd start at 700.
I may.
I'd start at 700. I'd accept 200, but I'd start at 700.
So you'd haggle.
Yeah.
You'd haggle your bustle. Your butthole.
100%.
Haggle your anal.
Yes.
Dude, the 100%. Other day, speaking of searching fast.
You already want it. He already wants it. So that's you got to start from that.
Oh, so yeah. I guess I would start high if he really wants it.
Sounds like I've done this before.
Yeah. I would start at like 500.
Is this how much money we're getting?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought I was paying him. I got a picture of my butthole here. Give you $200.
Take
it.
Oh,
fuck. I'm not gonna pay any more though.
You have a hard bargain. All right, 500.
Dude,
that's a great skit. Will you take my picture, my bow for $200? Like,
Well, I'm starting at 700.
Yeah. I won't go any lower.
I have to look at it for 20 seconds.
Whose feet are these rocks?
Oh, Kristen's.
Kirsten's.
Dude, look in her toes like never.
And that foot's.
Whoa. That's the money shot.
Who's that in the back, Rich? The little bobblehead she has.
Fuck if I know. Looks kind of like Andy Richter.
I barely know her.
Well.
All right.
And on that note.
Yeah, dude. So the other day, Sandra went to Rich's house and he looked up Legos super, super fast. So she wanted me to just talk about how she thinks you're faking your Googling skills.
Your lack thereof?
No, because he did it like really fast. He's like, oh, look at this set of Legos I want to get. And pulled it up really, really fast. But when he's here, he's real... So we think he's been lying so he can get off the Googling and get rocks back.
Like the deaf guy where you're like, hey, and turns around.
Yeah. Like son Stevie Wonder. Bitch. Is that true, Rich?
No.
Then
it's because it's a no, Mac.
I hope it's true. Because if it is true, then I don't look like such an asshole.
It's a Mac. And the keys are different.
Yeah, shut the fuck up.
That is not a difference, Roxanne.
Shut the fuck up. You didn't have a hard time today.
Don't give him an out.
I don't think you guys understand the anxiety this guy gives me when I fucking Google.
No, same.
Thank you.
Yeah.
How'd you feel today?
All right. Like whatever.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, because she's probably seen the body like, there's no way I can get it worse than Rich does.
Look at those feet.
Oh no.
Warren, that could be your real dad right there.
Do you get different results if you look up Bruce Jenner's
feet? Yeah.
Oh.
One star. Oh, that's worth at least three. I don't know. I think that's one
thing. Yeah, that is that's very transphobic.
Trolls.
He's not on here.
Very transphobic.
Bruce Jenner.
Because he changed his name, probably.
Two N's, E-R.
What?
What are you doing? Why aren't you spelling it?
He said E-R.
It would autocorrect.
Yeah, it would pop up.
What the fuck, dude?
That's crazy, because I'm sure... Shame. Look up on Google, Bruce Jenner's feet.
Safe search off.
Yeah.
There it is. Yeah,
there
baby.
We go.
That's a fucking running man right there. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
Look at—he just had his dick all out.
Would you rather? Okay,
dude, I see some pictures of my dad.
Fuck, marry, kill: Bruce Jenner, Caitlyn Jenner, and that chick that's his wife,
Kris
Jenner.
I would marry Kris Jenner.
Money.
Yeah, she's gonna make this podcast blow up. Then I would fuck Caitlyn Jenner and kill Bruce because he's kind of already dead.
Damn.
Wow, that's actually pretty progressive of you.
Thank you.
In a weird way.
It's Pride Month, baby.
Oh my gosh, I had a customer and he was like, oh yeah, it was actually my son driving. And I was like, oh, I don't see a son on here. And he was like, well, his name was Madeline, but now his name is Newt. So when you call him Newt. And in my head, the only thing I was thinking of, you got to pick your name.
That's what I was just thinking.
Newt?
Newt.
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 Newt. Newt. Like, come on.
Maybe.
N-E-W-T.
Maybe he was a big Aliens fan.
Yeah. Or maybe he was a big fan of the Newton boys.
Or Newt Gingrich.
Skeet Ulrich.
I guess, but it was pretty lame to me.
Oh, man.
What would you change your name to if you went into a female? I mean, became a female because you've done that part.
What would I change my name if I...
Warren, what are you changing your name to? If you transitioned?
Crystal.
Crystal green.
Crystal green.
All right. You already got the hair out of the way.
Popping bottles and pussy. Crystal green.
Dude, that sounds flawless.
Y'all have to answer first. I already know my answer.
I don't know my answer.
Mine is beautiful.
So you would change your name to a stripper name?
No, I'm saying my name is beautiful. Oh. Like,
are you describing
that's the actual name?
No, that's not the actual name. Oh, okay.
Mine's going to be beautiful.
Okay. Nice, dude. Solid name. Rich?
I'd probably go with Isabel because I would still have had a daughter.
Yeah, you, Isabel. Size.
That's really good.
The Liberty Bell, he means, because there's a lot of small bells out there.
Yeah, I got a crack.
They're all fucking bell size, though.
Bell shaped. I would go with Margaret.
Oh my God! Nobody would do anything.
My grandma's name.
Exactly. I want to be pure.
Then why are you becoming a woman? Like,
I don't know.
Aren't you becoming a woman to get more?
It was just that I was like.
I guess maybe a Maggie.
That's why they do it, right? To get more attention?
No, that's not why we do it, dude.
You know, some people like are detransitioning now because there was like such a phase of everybody.
Like they did it because it was popular, and now they're like, "Well, wait a second, I may have jumped again."
They have no clarity.
I'm not saying that's why all trans individuals do that. I'm sure some do it for the right reasons, but I'm sure there's a good population.
Use his mic. Oh God!
Hey, look,
people doing it. They doing it because shut up, Rich.
Hey, look, there's people.
People transition because they got mental illnesses.
Oh
wow!
Hot take.
Yeah.
No.
And how do we stop that, Mike?
How do we stop the mental illnesses?
Yeah.
Ketamine
therapy, dude.
Ketamine therapy. Look,
he wanted to be fucking Crystal his whole life. Once he started doing ketamine, he's become Warren Greed, the fucking comedian we all know and love.
Yeah, he's a man that doesn't fucking wipe his penis.
We didn't get Bean's answer, and we didn't get Rox's answer. She was a dude.
She said beautiful.
Troy.
Oh, you're like
gonna become white too.
Yeah.
Would you have a friend named Abed?
I don't know. Maybe.
Hey yo.
Are you gonna put a bunch of Trojans in people?
What's your beautiful name?
Probably.
Dude, if I was what's your beautiful name?
My beautiful name?
Mm-hmm.
I already said my name.
Margaret.
Oh, Margaret.
Yeah, Maggie? Exactly. But y'all won't want to
call
fuck
you
me
Maggie.
Though. Nope. Only Marge.
What about on, man. Marge?
Yeah.
Large Marge.
And I'm not changing any of my characteristics. I'm still gonna have a beard and hairy fucking. I just identify as Marge now.
So you're gonna be like AJ's sister?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wow. Call me Marge, bitch.
Ugh.
Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna be a lesbian.
Ugh. You should do that for like you do know in November.
Just become a lesbian?
For Pride Month, you should fucking...
Turn into Marge. All right. Hey, guys, I'm
can
Marge.
Can we get like clearance with Sandra that you could do that?
Yeah.
That'd be cool because you do know not November. That's for the men, right? You got to be equal.
Equal, right.
February, so. You might be able to do something about that.
Do I have to wear a wig? Because I'm not fine with that.
For February.
Why not?
Okay. Can I get my nails done?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, bet.
In November, you can become an Indian, right?
Like a dot or a feather?
Whichever you want. Just feather. Eat turkey. Make sure you have the turkey.
Wise men.
February.
Not wise men. What is it called?
What could you do in February?
Casinos?
Be black. Can you wear a blackface?
Reservation.
Yeah. Oh, maybe don't do February.
I'm not doing
black. Maybe skip February.
I'll just dress up as Cupid. A little cute little.
Yeah. Maybe just like.
No shirt. Just a little diaper on.
Just go to jail.
With an arrow and heart.
Just go to jail during the month of February.
Don't blend in.
And then in March.
Don't try to blend in though.
In solidarity.
You know what, guys? I'm detransitioning. This is too much.
All right, let's wrap this baby up. We've been 2.5 hours in. Warren Greed, thank you so much. Make sure you guys are going to his June 28th. Is it going to be a monthly show?
It's going to be so far. Yeah.
And if it's successful.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
awesome.
Next one's in the books on the schedule for end of July too. So.
Oh, let's go. Awesome.
Fuck yeah.
What are your Instagrams and social medias?
It's at Warren Greed. Warren Greed.
Not Howard. Crystal Greed.
Two R's. Two E's, three E's actually. There's a D in there. There's a G and a W at the beginning.
There's a D in there.
It's an N in the middle. You guys will figure it out.
War and Greed.
He is
there's
autistic.
An A too.
Dude, but real quick about War and Greed. Did your parents know like War and Greed?
And did you know until today?
Did they make the plan? Yeah, no.
You've always played with it?
Yeah, you know, that's why I picked the name.
When you transition that to you.
Well, thank you, Warren, for coming and enjoying your Sunday with us. Fuck Alonzo can too.
Yes.
And your shirt will be blurred out through the whole video here.
Why? It's just a giant dick. Can
yeah, if your episode even happens, because the goal to show up with that shirt. Thank you so much. No, we appreciate you, bro, man. You're super fucking hilarious. Keep doing what you do. I love watching every single time. Thank you so much.
All right.
Yeah, make sure you hit the like, subscribe, and go follow Warren Greed, BFR Podcast. We're out.
Express VPN.
Whoop-de-doo. What does it all mean, Basil?